The girl from Runaway with a whole lot of shit to say. It's your girl, KD.
It's your hostess with the mostest. It's Kiki.
What up, though? It's your boy, DTM, the Dr. DTM, a.k.a. Pure Motivation. I am Mr. Energy. Everybody love me. I don't have one enemy. Our podcast is here, so you got to respect it. You never get off on us, because we're never the exit. Oh! So it's your boy, Mandy TM. What's good?
Oh, that was fire. You know
what
I
mean? I like that.
You know, we're never the exit.
Never the exit. Never get off right here. You know what I mean? So what's good? And how was y'all weekend?
It was cool. It was interesting as usual. Usual.
Usual. KD, how was your weekend?
It was good. Good. Fantabulous.
Okay, I was about to say, I don't like good, but fantabulous. I like fantabulous.
I had some good sex last night, so that was good.
Shaboing boing.
That always make your day better.
You did. Shaboing
boing. I woke up this morning like, hey, mm-hmm. I don't care we don't got no lights.
It wasn't even cold when we were doing neither. You notice that?
Well, yeah, it's cold. Not supposed to be.
It wasn't cold till we got from up under them blankets. I was like, oh hell no.
When we finished, it was like,
yeah, that's how you feel it.
It's so funny because usually we cuddle for like 5-10 minutes and then I go to my side of the bed, he go on his side of the bed. So no, last night we cuddled all night.
All night.
So for those who
don't, cold.
Y'all probably wondering what we're talking about. We did pay our DTE, but what happened was we had a windstorm here. And the windstorm was all day and everything was good. But when the windstorm was over, 3-4 hours later, the power decided to go out due to the windstorm.
Doesn't
that was not
it always
even here
happen
anymore.
Like that?
So,
after the storm. Like, that's right. So weird.
So, that was definitely an issue for us. Like, okay, put it up on the ground, so we don't have to worry about that. But...
Right, like the other cities.
Right. But, you know, we still made do. You know what I'm saying? It was already nighttime. My baby said, nope, I need some kind of noise, though. So, she was making noise. You feel me?
Not too much, though. The house was too quiet, though. I kept hearing shit and... Then the kids they was watching TV on their phone, but it was so loud. I was like, oh, the lights are back on. And I woke out of my eyes like, well, what the fuck they down there watching?
No, here's a kicker now. Pops had a flashlight.
Uh-oh.
This flashlight was brighter than the freaking sun.
Yes.
Oh. I thought the power was on. I'm like, that coming from that one? He was like, nothing but the best. I said, all right now.
You're like, because you got to see when you can't see.
You got to see. When your eyes are open, you got to be able to see what you need to see when you see it.
Mm-hmm. All righty.
I said, all right, hey.
And if they ask who said it, tell them it was me.
Mm-hmm.
So, for me, man, my weekend was pretty good, pretty phenomenal. I'm going to go on record and say that I got to perform a ceremony of two of my most favorite people. Not my only favorite people, but two of my most favorite couples. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
I got to perform their ceremony.
It was so pretty.
Again. Yeah.
Right.
So they had, we married them last year, but it was just them. So nobody knew, you know,
what was going on.
Then they had the ceremony this year.
Mm-hmm.
And they was like, we definitely got to have y'all come do it. And I'm like,
that's nice.
I'm like, we doing that on the love just because.
Mm-hmm.
They was like, all right, bet. But then they was like, nah, we want to give you something. We really
of
love
course.
Y'all. So mm-hmm. I'm like, that's what's up, you know?
She was like, no, we got to give you something.
And when I tell you, it was beautiful.
It was so pretty.
It was lit. Like, they turned up on their interest as they was walking in.
He came into, I felt like the man when I walked through.
Hey.
And the way they had it set up, how people was coming in, it was amazing. Like,
yeah.
I'm like... And KD was like, I didn't even get to see it because she was in the back with the bride.
Because I was trying to help with that freaking... Let me tell you something. We've done probably over 100 weddings. I have never, ever, ever seen a train that long.
Mm.
Like, and not in real life. Like, probably like on TV or something. But her freaking train was so... I said, is this detachable? She was like, no, I have to bustle it. I said,
what?
I'm not bustling this.
Oh, my goodness.
Because I normally help with the bustle. But hell no.
That's too much. They did a braid ceremony. Kiki, you ever heard of that?
A who?
A braid ceremony.
Mm-mm. It was cool.
So, yeah. So, a braid ceremony is like a unity piece of ceremony where you braid three strands together.
Mm-hmm.
And the strands represent you, your new spouse,
mm-hmm.
and God.
Okay.
So, you know, you braid it together. It's definitely dope, man.
So, what are we braiding? What exactly?
It's like a three ropes.
Oh, okay.
That's connected to a cross.
Okay.
And it, you know, it's a good keepsake.
Mm.
You know, most
I've
people,
never heard that. That's interesting.
Some people do sand. Sand is very common. The candle is very common.
Yeah,
I like sand. Sand my favorite.
But the braid ceremony is not as common, but
I've never heard of it.
Beautiful.
Yeah. They did the brave ceremony and they jumped the broom.
And they jumped the broom.
And she fucked her ankle up.
And she had that long train.
Because her dress, not only was her train long, but her dress was like super puffy. So her dress reminded me of like a Cinderella dress, right? Because it was like super, it was like skinny at the top and then super puffy. And then you got this freaking 12-mile long chain, I mean train. And you trying to jump. Even when she was walking down the aisle, she almost tripped. Her dad had to hold the front of it. It was just so much dress.
That's crazy. Yeah, she should have had a person like specifically for that.
That's what I told her. I said, who?
Because that's a lot.
Like we, it was three people. It was three people holding the train while she was trying to jump the broom.
Oh,
just
my
to make
goodness.
Sure that, you know.
Yeah.
She didn't. And even then, I still heard it like caught on to something. But it wasn't that bad. You couldn't really see where
it caught. I felt like I would have felt like it would have been a disaster if it wasn't done.
Yeah. But it came out good, man. And
that's good.
And I was telling KD, I said, you can tell the good people in the industry because you always tend to run back past them again at the next ceremony. Because we're like, oh, that's the DJ from the... Oh, that's the coordinator from the... Oh, that, you know what I mean? So, like, when you start running into the
one lady was
people.
Like, y'all look so familiar. I was like, I think we did a wedding. I mentioned the couple. And she was like, oh, yeah. She was like, I had asked her for y'all information because I wanted to work with you all again. So, I had gave her a card and with our information or whatever. Because she was like, because you are so helpful. I was like, oh, thank you.
So, you know, it was a lot of fun. I loved it, man.
Then, so she had this... her guest book was a phone. So you're supposed to pick up the phone, leave a message, and then later on, the couple will hear the message from you. So instead of having to write it down, you just say, like, this message from whoever, da-da-da-da-da.
Who about to listen to that? I'd rather just look at it.
The problem is it was actually supposed to be hooked up to a phone jack.
Yeah, and
it
wasn't. Old school,
which,
who has phone
jacks? Who the hell has phone jacks? So... they were like asking the people at the venue, like, hey, where's the phone jacks? And they were like, phone jacks? Nowhere.
Know what phone jack like, is. Like, what is the phone jack?
Right, what's that?
What? The one girl was like, what do you mean phone jack? So they're like, because she was young.
I told you.
The first girl was like super young.
My kids will have no idea what a regular phone is.
So, so they're like, well, how do you guys have phones? She's like, Wi-Fi? Like, their quote-unquote landline is actually hooked up through their... what's it called? Internet. So
nothing is needed.
So they were like, well, who's gonna tell her? And I was like, well, why does she need to be told? Because it's my thing. It's nothing we can do about it. It's not like you can fucking invent a jack.
Somebody should have run out and got a book though at that point.
I said,
because now you have nothing.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying?
So that's what I told the coordinator. I said, well, if there's no backup, I mean, I don't. But the thing is, they put it out late anyway. The ceremony was about to start.
Yeah.
So at that point, it was no time to even. So I was like, I don't know. We can think of something, but telling her is not an option.
No,
because why does she need to know?
Yeah.
Right.
It's nothing that we can fix. Yeah. So why go to her like, oh, and by the way, her freaking bridesmaids already left her her vials at the hotel.
What?
She was like, nobody grabbed my book. Girl, they all looked at each other like, what book? That's like what book?
Like
fire.
It.
Oh, that's fire.
That one?
That one fire.
You welcome.
That one fire right there.
You welcome.
All right, so I got this new segment that we are going to try out on this podcast that we do on our other podcast. And you probably listening, you like, other podcast? What other podcast? Where the heck have you been? Living under a rock? Well, let me tell you. We got a few more podcasts to add to Relationship Reality.
You're stupid.
You don't have to go subscribe to a new channel or anything. You know why? Because it's going to pop up right here if you are already subscribed, because it plays everywhere. It plays on iHeart. It plays on Google Podcast. It plays on Apple Podcast, YouTube, or
wherever you get your podcast.
You dig? So you don't have to do anything extra. All you got to do is listen and share and tell a friend to tell a friend. But the other podcast is called Marriage Material. That's with yours truly, your boy DTM, and
your girl KD.
And then we also have Whoop Talk.
Whoop Talk.
And that's with yours truly, Kiki.
Kiki.
And
your girl KD.
KD. And
your girl Chucko.
Chuck. So
the girl with the contagious energy. It's me, Chucko.
That's it.
Trying to help.
That's it.
She actually does too.
She really does have contagious energy. She definitely the nice friend.
She's definitely the nice one.
She definitely the friend that you would have to fuck somebody up about not being right to her. Because she's so nice.
For sure.
Period.
Like,
period.
I say I'm nice, but she's really nice.
No,
she's really nice.
No, me and you have nothing on her, nothing. Okay? We no are the mean girls. She, okay?
No cap.
She's that the part. Nice one.
First of all, if you're comparing us to her, we're like the evil
twins. That, for sure.
That's period.
We're evil sisters.
No cap.
Definitely.
That part. That's period.
That's period. That's on that.
That's on that.
That and that's on that.
Period. You're just no going cap. To agree with everything.
That part.
You're
so right. So if you just make sure you take a listen to it, man. When it, when you see it pop up on Monday or you see something pop up on Friday, and I got something else working in the mix. I don't know if I'm gonna do Tuesday or Thursday, but it's about to be amazing. We finna take up your whole week. We finna give you some ooh. good.
The good thing is you're gonna have something to listen to at work.
At work
every day.
And that's what we want, man. We want
that's
you to,
how I am.
We want you to be. We want to consume your whole day.
Don't Wednesday took a long time to come. Okay,
it's like, we don't even want you to have to try to figure out what am I gonna listen to today. You already know.
Yeah, and then it's like by the time you done laugh with us for an hour and a half, 2 hours, your day almost over. It's, right. It's time for your first break.
And then the next one, yeah, then the next one come on for the second break, and then boom, then bam, then the bada boom. All right, so
bada boom, bada bang, you know that right thing. Back.
So this new segment that we do on Marriage Material that I'm gonna try out right here with you guys, it's called Worth a Shot.
Okay.
And Worth a Shot is we are gonna kind of we listen to, you know, news and we hear stuff and everything like that. If you hear some stuff that's off the wall to you, I want y'all to just jot it down. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, I bring got one it to the show. The
and when you bring it to the show, what we're going to do is we're going to hear the story or the situation, and then we're going to gauge whether or not it's worth a shot.
Worth a shot.
And if it's worth a shot, we're going to take a shot. Mm. If it's not worth a shot, then maybe the person who found it should take two shots. I don't know. We'll figure this thing out. Well, we'll work it out as we get through.
You made that
up. You know what I'm saying? Something got to happen if you just
so the worth the shot got to be like some crazy shit we saw on the news or something, right?
Yeah, just something off the wall. You know what I'm saying?
Got it.
You, it could be something you heard on the news. It could be something you read. You know what I'm saying? It could be something that somebody that you know actually went through. You know what I'm saying? You're like, oh my God, let me tell you what happened. We was at the bubble and, you know.
The bubble?
Yeah, yeah.
Are you talking about when we went last year for Kiki's birthday?
Yeah, yeah. Uh-huh. We was at the bubble and boom.
Well,
and
we
that they, was fun, though.
They zipped us in and then they turned the heat on and it was too hot. You know, it's just something crazy.
Right,
I don't
we
know.
Like, we drunk. Can you turn the heat down before we throw up?
It was colder first.
So,
three shots later.
Right. So, what I have for you guys for this one for Worth a Shot. Is the question that I'm gonna ask first is so did you know that if I rob a bank, right, and then I put the money in my account for whatever strange reason that it is, and then I withdraw the money from my account, I just added a whole new charge? Did you know that?
Yeah, I don't know nothing about the charges as far
as why would you
the bank?
Well, I don't know
why
you
put would
in,
you
I don't know.
So you can rob it from one bank, go to another bank and deposit it. So what's the new charge? Laundering?
It's, I'll get to it in just a second. But, so what I have for us today is, it comes from Arizona. Straight out of the AZ. You know what I'm saying?
If shout my brother
out,
listening to this, fuck out. You, because I called you 17 times last night.
Jive turkey.
I was drunk, but still.
Jive turkey. All right, so, So this one came by the AZ, and I felt like this was worth a shot because of who's involved. All right. So sometimes stuff happens with people. You'd be like, "Wait, you did that?
Mm-hmm.
You should be involved in something like that." But all right, so
something like that.
A Phoenix police officer.
Oh.
Has resigned and been arrested.
Oh.
Amid accusations of
what?
The PPP loan fraud.
Oh my God!
What?
The former officer Tony Richardson.
Oh, you gonna say his name?
It's
to
her.
Oh. It's
to
her.
Is facing charges after alleged falsifying a loan application for the Paycheck Protection Program. She was able to obtain more than $1.2 million in government loans for a business that had no employees.
First of all,
federal prosecutor says. So Richardson took the money and used it on personal expenses, according to the Arizona Republic. Her and her co-conspirator, in whom she told it was us together.
Bitch, we did this together.
Are facing charges of conspiracy, bank fraud,
I hate people
and
like
transactional
that.
Money laundry. And that's where it comes into play when you put it in the bank.
Oh, I was right.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So transactional money laundry.
Mm.
So she had a business and it was called the Lotto Club. And it's supposed to be a non-profit organization for veterans.
Why did you do veteran. That one? The Lotto Club.
She had that. She listed that she had over. She was 100% ownership, and that she had over 85 employees.
Oh,
which.
First of all, with you said average, you're 100%, so how am I your co-conspirator?
With the average monthly payroll right. of $500,000 on the application.
For 85 people?
For 85 what people.
The Wait, $500,000 a month?
Yes.
How much fucking money do these people make?
So, she is now facing charges, and she's waiting right now to see what's going to happen. This is, like, really going down. As we speak,
that's crazy.
But
she got the dumbest.
That's ever. like $5,800. Well, $5,900 a month.
Month.
Mm-hmm. Per person.
A lot of money.
Yeah.
So you damn near making $6,000 a
that's
month.
That's a lot of money.
Where the fuck you work at?
And it's a non-profit organization,
right?
For veteran. So yeah. So what y'all think, man? Y'all think that was worth the shot, or?
I just want to see one more thing.
She wants to see one more thing.
That's quick. Like $1,500 a week. Where the fuck?
Yeah, like getting that bread. But
they
I mean,
hiring?
Here's
oh,
the,
it's
but
fake.
No, this is the thing though. This is the thing. Nonprofit organizations make money, right?
Yeah,
and they make good money.
Yeah.
One of the places that I deliver to, most of the stuff that they get is given to you, so they're not spending money
Much
to make
coming.
The money.
Yeah.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So everything they're getting in donation money, material,
food,
etc. So I be looking. I seen they one spot that I delivered to. They gave. I think I can say the name of the place that they gave it to. Forgotten Harvest.
Mm-hmm.
Like 10 big screen TVs. It was all type of food on a daily basis, though.
Right.
All you got to do is come pick it up.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Sign it, and you go.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So, everything, basically, if you bring something back.
Like,
and you say.
Lehman's, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Or if you bring something back and you're like, yeah, I just bought this laptop and it had a cracking screen on the top. Or it's defected, you know, for whatever reason. They take it, they set it in the back, they write it off, and then they give it to these
oh,
companies.
Oh, okay.
So, mm-hmm. you got a new laptop that, you know, who cares if it's a little crack if you didn't really pay for it, for real?
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying?
And then some of that stuff be so small, like at the Sears warehouse, remember where we got a washer from there?
Mm-hmm.
And he like, okay, I do got to show you this scratch, but it was like at the bottom, in the back, up under something. And
right.
I'm like, who can even see that? He was like, but once it got that little bitty something, you can't sell it at Sears.
Mm.
So you have to sell it at the outlet.
Okay.
So nah. It could have been anything. It could have been like when they were like moving it, they scratched it. So now it goes there like for like half the price.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, it's free, but.
I don't want to put the dude out there, so I'm not going to say his name.
Okay, well, that's
but
nice.
But he was a delivery person. For companies like that.
Mm-hmm.
And when he didn't want to deliver, he would take the stuff out of the box, put a scratch on it, and then boom, I can't deliver it because it has a scratch.
Mm.
So really, he's just driving around for 8-9 hours, taking it back to the warehouse because he don't want to deliver and really do the work. And
I wonder how long it took them to fire him.
They was,
cause
he
how
was
the
there
fuck
for some years.
How every time you get something, it got a scratch on it.
Mm-hmm.
Nobody else but your ass.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so what we saying? Was that worth a shot?
Yeah, that was
yeah,
that was
shot.
That was off the
shot,
chain.
Shot.
Everybody,
it's so good.
It is. Now I'm gonna let KD give it. You know, what are we drinking today?
We haven't named it yet.
I think we did.
What we name
did.
It?
You said 100%. What'd you say? Sugar free KD. I'm like that. That's what you're saying.
Sugar-free KD.
That's what you saying.
I like that name though. I want something catchier.
Catchier. Okay, well, it's no name.
It's no name, but it's so good.
But you don't have to give the ingredient, but you want to kind of describe what it.
So it's
a calorie
it's,
free.
It's no calories.
It's a calorie
it's no
free
sugar,
drink.
No carbs. Drink. So we're like literally drinking air, but enjoying it.
The air up there.
Like,
so good,
like
so.
If you're calorie counting or like any counting, any carb counting, anything. Like if you're
What's
on a keto diet,
yeah.
If you're on a keto diet. So this drink can be used for whatever. Even if you're not, because Kiki 120 pounds, she ain't counting shit.
I wish.
But
girl, thank you.
But I'm just saying, but it's a way to like just enjoy a drink with no really no after effect, because most of the time if you remove the sugar and the carbs from a drink, you won't have a hangover.
Mm.
So I'm not gonna say all the time, because I mean, if you overdo anything, of course you're gonna have residuals of it the next day.
Right.
I think the worst thing is you might wake up still drunk, but you won't have a hangover.
Still drunk from
yesterday. Normally, you won't have a hangover.
And so this is.
And it doesn't really give you like nauseous or, you know what I'm saying, some of the things that overdrinking gives you.
And this is something that you'll probably hear on a regular now.
Oh my God, it's so good.
It's so good.
Katie stepping into what she loved to do. She loved to create
making drinks.
Drinks and things of that nature. So she'll hear some.
I should have been a bartender instead of a pharmacy tech.
Boom. Mm-hmm. You know. So
no, we don't want you in a bar every night.
If you
want to work for people.
If you want to hear the off the wall thing that I have for us on marriage material, you have to tune in.
What off the wall?
The worth the shot.
Oh.
I got
one too.
Okay. Oh man.
Hope I remember.
So you want to do yours now?
No.
Okay.
No.
Right.
I'm going to think of something again.
Yeah.
So you got right down. Write down. So
no, I remember it because some shit you don't forget. Like that nigga did what?
So let me ask y'all this question. Do y'all have a couple that y'all like idolize, that you really hate that, you know, for them to break up or go through anything?
Mm-hmm.
Who's y'all couple?
Y'all for me. Fuck. I never want y'all to break up. Fuck, 22 years, I'd be devastated. Okay? Fuck.
Not she. I will be devastated. Y'all better not.
That's my couple.
Like, we really are. That's like, my a couple, lot of people's Jay-Z and Beyonce. Okay.
Yeah, I'm about to say, so for most people with Jay-Z and Beyonce.
It's my couple.
For a lot of people, for me, now this couple is a different type of a couple.
I don't know a whole lot of couples that's real like y'all.
Like what about?
You know what I'm saying? Like
yeah.
Y'all do everything together. Y'all like a couple. Most couples are together, but just together. You know what I mean?
They're together because they're scared forever, not to be.
But still, yep. Like unhappy. Like not to say y'all ever like not happy at moments, but I mean y'all a real couple. Like y'all be on some real shit.
Yeah, BFF
positive,
get to see
negative,
like
everything.
Our everything. Not yeah, just the shit we
but
post.
Most right. couples, I gotta say about 80% of the couples I know are just together because of the kids, because
of convenience. Years. Yep. Mm-hmm.
You know, they're not really happy, they're just together. So I don't idolize that. Like I like couples that are real and yeah. have real shit going on. Like
I think one of my favorite couples would be my aunt and my uncle. Cause they've been together for like 30 something years, but they've been through everything. Like mm-hmm. literally from like financial things mm-hmm. to like drug abuse to shit, literally everything. Mm-hmm. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like
right.
affairs, like they've literally, I don't think it's a mountain they haven't conquered mm-hmm. together. But when you see them together, you know they really like to be together.
Yeah,
like,
you can see the love.
Yeah.
Like, that's what you like yep. to see in a relationship, like the love.
Yeah.
Like, you could just be together with anybody, but no, I want to see that love. Like,
yeah. like they
still
they,
got
they,
that spark. Like,
yeah, they like they had a moment when my little cousin moved out and got married, where they were like, "Damn, who are you?
What we gonna do?"
Because she actually the one who told me.
That's what usually
yeah,
couples do.
Because she like,
you
was
all
a
about the kids. And
yeah,
then boom, they out.
And then it's like
now you
got
to really get to know your spouse. Like,
yeah.
do we really like each other?
Yeah.
And maybe like
she, but she was the one who told
you
she
tell
me and DTM all the time, like,
you gotta get to
don't
know
forget
again,
to date
yep.
don't forget to enjoy
yep.
yourself, so that way when your kids are gone
you still like each
you
other.
Still like each other. So what they started doing is they started traveling
mm-hmm.
yeah.
like they just got back from like Alaska or something crazy, like
mm-hmm.
you know, it's crazy to me because I don't like the cold
mm-hmm.
so going to Alaska is not nowhere near my bucket list, so
mm-hmm,
like
mm-hmm.
if I had an anti-bucket list it would be on there because it's cold as hell. She my auntie Berta said, I mean, oh well, but she said,
oh my god,
hey, that
right.
is so
oh
good
well.
She said that,
oh my god,
this
her Michigan coat,
the Simply Air is amazing. I'm just trying to
she,
say y'all.
She said oh, the, oh I like that Simply Air.
Mm.
She said that
like
man, I'm a marketer out here. Y'all come holler at me. Y'all need help.
She said that like they took like all their Michigan coats or whatever, and they ended up having to buy coats there that had inside warmers. That's how cold it is there.
Yeah, that's not said, on my bucket what? List at all. Okay, I need to
I go. Never want to go there. She was like, but it's so pretty. I will look at the pictures. I'm gonna look at the pictures.
Yeah, I'm never
going there. You know why we said that?
It's never gonna be on my bucket list.
You know why we say that though? Because we say that because we live here. In a cold
yeah,
area.
It's cold here. Yeah.
Like we experience cold here. Like I can see people from like California.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? The
but
the
she's from here too.
Yeah, but she's not really mentally from here. She's from everywhere mentally. Like,
she probably she's mentally somewhere tropical.
Yeah. Mentally she's bi-coastal, so she
She said
I wonder that.
I was like, so you had to buy a coat there with a heater inside? Like,
that's crazy.
That sounds crazy.
That's too I just seen a vest like that. And for some strange reason I really wanted it. But I kept saying to myself, what for? Like, right. I'm not going to be outside like that. That's not outside.
My brother got coats like that because he work outside.
But I do have an outside.
Like that, then
yeah.
I do have outside life, you know what I'm saying? But it's early morning, but I'm not out that long.
I was about to say, you not outside.
Yeah, like, yeah. I go from a whip to the inside of a building.
Right.
And then from the building to the whip.
Right.
Now, I might have to invest in some water boots if it keep raining and flooding like it's been doing here.
Yeah.
And this flooding is not where it's at. Not where it's at, man. So for me, man, my favorite couple that I look at is actually my mentor, and you wouldn't even think that, like, this dude is a celebrity, but he's very reachable. You know what I mean? So I really talk to him on a regular. You know what I'm saying? And his name is E.T. He's a motivational speaker as well. And his wife, D.D., you know, shout out to y'all. But they've been together for like almost 30 plus years.
Wow.
Too.
Oh, yeah.
That's and sweet. For them, they haven't been through our same battles that we went through, but they've been through a lot as well.
Of
and, they,
course.
And they can tell you, you know, how to get through X, Y, and Z. And I feel like sometimes in a relationship, you got to have that person that you look up to in a relationship, like something to strive for.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So, like, you ain't waking up every day just going.
Mm-hmm.
What you going for? What you trying to do? Right. What you trying to accomplish?
Mm-hmm.
And, like, it's the same thing even with, it, like, in your profession. When we went through our last situation with the whole reverse money refund, whatever, and shout out to her because she made it right.
She actually did make it right.
She made it right. You know what I'm saying?
I didn't even have to pull up on her mother-in-law.
And I feel like we kept the integrity. You know what I'm saying? I reached out to her on some regular. And she kept it. We kept the integrity, and she felt it. I think she felt the sincerity in things that we were talking about.
I think she felt that.
And
she should.
And you know, she made it right, and I was like, "That's what's up." So shout out to her. But even in business, so I got my homeboy. He's been on the show a few times, Angelo. And I reached out. You know, I'm like, "Yo, you do a lot of online orders and stuff like that. What do you do if X, Y, and Z happens? What do you do in this aspect?" What made you feel like you wanted to go to this type of conference? So what made, you know what I'm saying? Like, I want to pick your brain because you know, at a different level. And we sit and we kick, we have boss conversations, and that's how you grow.
Oh, yeah.
But people don't have boss relationship conversation.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Only time people have a relationship conversation is when they complaining. Let me tell you what she did.
Yep.
Or let me tell you what he did. Like, no, you got to have a boss conversation where you're really trying to accomplish something within it. You know what I'm saying? So, when thinking of that relationship, this is about to be gone, but you don't have to make another one yet. Simply Air is amazing. Shout out to Simply Air. They're going to sponsor the next podcast. You know what I'm saying? In thinking of that, my question is this, too. And they kind of go together. You know what I'm saying? Like a segue. I was going to push it, but I let it go. Segway.
Listen. I let it go.
But you know how they say, if you are like addicted to drugs, right? And one person want to get off drugs. You really shouldn't hang out with people who are not trying to get off drugs.
Yeah.
If you're trying to get off drugs.
Yeah.
What do y'all think about that in relationship? You know what I'm saying? Like if you hanging out with people who don't have the best, you know, mental space for relationship, but you in your head, you're like, no, I want my relationship to really last. Do you think you should like limit your time with them people as well?
I think
and then
so.
How do you do it if them people are very staple individuals in your life? You know what I'm saying?
That's
like,
hard.
Like,
especially if you're close to those people.
Like, what if it's us three, right? And I'm like, I really want to be the best husband. And Katie's like, I really want to be the best wife. Mm-hmm. And Kiki like, man, F that relationship stuff, man. I'm about to, I'm out here doing X, Y, and Z. Relationship don't work. And so since Kiki's a very staple individual in our lives, how would you handle that? Because you don't want to limit how much you hang with her because this is our BFF, right? Mm-hmm. And for the most part, depending on where she is mentally, you're not going to change her mind. Sometimes people had a mindset because something just happened. Mm-hmm. And sometimes they had a mindset because something happened for so long that they like, nah, I'm straight for a while. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? So you might, you know, you can change one of the minds, but the other one you can't change.
But I feel like it shouldn't be a matter. Oh, I was about to say, what the hell? I don't think it should be a matter of like changing her mind. I feel like she's entitled to feel how she feels, mm-hmm. as long as she respects that I'm in a relationship. Mm-hmm. Like
that part.
Like don't you can hate relationships. You can be anti-relationship all you want, but like every time we hang out, it shouldn't be two guys at the bar waiting on us. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Or mm-hmm. or we somewhere eating and we look up and you got two niggas coming in. Like no, it should only be one nigga. It should not be two unless both of them leaving with you.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So it's like think how you think, feel how you feel, but respect me as well. You know what I'm saying? Because every time we sit down, I'm not gonna be like, so girl, when you about to get you a mm-hmm. when you gonna settle down? Mm-hmm. Like no, that's your choice.
Yeah,
so don't try to fuck my shit up.
Yeah,
because you don't mentally respect the entity of marriage. That's and I know that for a fact because I actually went through that with someone.
Yeah. That's why too. I asked that, because for one, nobody talked about this type of stuff, right? Mm-hmm. And for two, we always say, you know, two drug addicts, if you try to get off drugs, you shouldn't hang out with people who doing it and mm-hmm. want to do it. You got to hang out with somebody who's on your same mindset, right? Mm-hmm. We never talk about that relationship. We never talk about it, even in like the poverty mindset. Mm-hmm. If mm-hmm. you just a broke nigga in your head, and that's all you talk about, that's all you want to do, and then somebody else is looking into like stock and mm-hmm. Bitcoin and trying mm-hmm. to figure out, trying to learn, not like on some get rich quick, but just on like some, I'm trying to be financially free. Oh, yeah. They working on like mm-hmm. credit scores and right. stuff. But they got you over here like, no, we finna go to the party. We finna throw this.
Yeah.
I feel like you gotta distance yourself from people like that a little bit, I feel like.
Yeah, and that's the thing.
I have. Because it starts to like weigh you down, mm-hmm. like for me. And it's like, now all you wanna do is party and hang out. And I'm like, nah, I wanna work and fucking make some money, open a business and do some other shit. It's like, it's almost like you in two different levels. Like, mm-hmm. and it's that you don't want them to pull you down. You trying to elevate them. Mm-hmm. But if they not getting it, it's like, you gotta distance yourself.
Because the problem is negativity spreads faster than positivity.
So fast.
And that's just the way of life. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Like definitely. You said, like, mm-hmm. if you post something like, me and my wife out celebrating our anniversary, you mm-hmm. might get 17 likes and 15 comments. But if you like, fuck that bitch, I'm through with her, mm-hmm. you're gonna get 1500 likes and 2500 comments. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying?
It's and just 4,000 DMs.
Because everybody wanna know. You know, people be nosy. Yeah. They wanna know what's going on.
And it's, you know what I'm saying? Like, post a fight video. Yeah. That shit gonna go viral so fast.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But if you post a motivational video, so you don't got 5 minutes to watch a motivational video, but you got 25 minutes to watch a fight video.
And you'll watch the whole thing.
Again. Because you're gonna show somebody like, girl, come here, let me show you this.
And you're gonna commentate as you show it to somebody else.
You're gonna watch the video and then you're gonna go to the people pages and see what the fight was about. Like, you gotta do your investigation,
like all types of shit. And that's just
the negative shit. Yeah. But if somebody posts about their business, you're not gonna go back and look and see what the business. I mean, I do because I like to support people.
Yeah.
But most people not gonna go back and look at the business and share and like and fucking support and buy.
It don't cost nothing to share a post. People be
cheap. Yep. They be cheap when it comes to them, but.
Or they want a deal.
When it comes to other people.
Or they want a deal.
But yeah.
What's the discount?
Mm-hmm.
What? Bitch, when you bought that Gucci purse, did you ask for a discount?
Right.
Mm. No. When you ain't got your hair and your nails done, you asked for a discount. Right. So, but mm-hmm. that's just how it is. Like, so I feel like that's why sometimes you when you trying to elevate yourself, you do have to distance yourself from people who comfortable mm-hmm. where they are.
Yeah.
Because you don't want their negativity to get on you. Because mm-hmm. it's not your positivity could get on them, but it's not likely.
Right. Mm-hmm. And that's what I was talking about too, because this conversation came about because I was talking about people of poverty mm-hmm. with the poverty mindset, right?
Yeah.
And I'm like, and I had a conversation with two different people. One was speaking like, yeah, I'm trying to learn Bitcoin, I'm trying to learn mm-hmm. you know, the NFTs, I'm trying to learn this because I really want to set up, you know, for my kids and this and the third, right?
Mm-hmm.
And the other one was like, I ain't on all that. I'm trying to go work. You know what I'm saying? We've been living check to check for a while. I'm just trying to get this money.
I hate that. The mentality of check to check is horrible.
Like, you saying you live check to check.
But that's the things you do when you in high school. Like, in high school, you live check to check. So, in your 30s, you should not be living check to check. Right. You should be doing something different in your 30s. I'm sorry.
And that's the thing.
I'm sorry.
But you have to, for one, be exposed to it. So, I was on a call. Yeah. I was on a motivational call this week. And they were just talking about exposure, mm-hmm. right? You don't realize that you're living normal or beneath your wing, mm-hmm. your mean, until you're exposed to something different. Yeah,
that's true.
You know what I'm saying? So you get so comfortable in life with because my mom was like this and mm-hmm. my grandparents was like this and we always been like this. So if you can do small stuff like get your Christmas shopping done 2 weeks before Christmas. Mm-hmm. You feel like you winning.
You're good.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
If you can do, like, you know, small stuff like save $100 from your last check mm-hmm. until you get to this check, you feel like you're doing something good.
Yeah. You're like, I'm not living check to check. I got $100.
I got $100.
Got $100, right?
I can't do much with it.
But then you get exposed to somebody.
That is gas for me. My gas like $70.
You ain't lying.
Right.
So you get exposed to somebody who's like, you know, or before I even talk about exposure, you go to the restaurant and you're like, oh, okay, let me see. I'm going to get, ain't no price next to this one right here. How much is this? Or how much, what's the price on it?
Mm-hmm.
And then you get exposed to somebody who like, no, we doing left side of the menu. If you're in the poverty mindset, you don't even know that mean nothing.
Yeah.
You like, left side, what that mean? Mm-hmm. I look on both sides. I'm trying to figure out.
I didn't see nothing on either side.
Right, I look on both sides. You know what I'm saying? Like, and of course, we always down spirit because
mm-hmm.
they are horrible.
They are horrible.
But there's a way to make your spirit flight feel better.
Yeah.
You just have to, for one, be in a different mindset.
You got
to
pay more.
Yeah. You got to pay a little bit more. You got to be in a different mindset.
But if I'm going to pay more, I'm going to a different airline. It's my thing. Because if I'm going with spirit, it's because the flight was
$30. Right.
So if I got to pay $20 for my seat, I might as well, and my bags, I might as well just go on Delta.
Right, and that's the thing. So, like, once you get out of the poverty mindset, you really stop looking for mm-hmm. the cheap flights.
Mm-hmm.
And you start looking for the flight that you want.
I would say, like,
some comfortable
flights. If you're going to, like, Chicago, get a Spirit flight. You know what I'm saying?
If it's
like,
something within less than 2 hours.
But if we going to, like,
Vegas.
Vegas.
Four and a half hours.
And then Arizona was a long flight. Like, no. We're
not
flying
Spirit. I can't do anything over 2 hours.
And that's
Atlanta.
And I still buy my seat because I like to sit by the window.
So I hate sitting. I'm such a chicken. I don't want to sit by the window.
Because it's just more comfortable.
I'm scared of heights, so I can't.
You can always close the shade.
I just like to sleep
on the window side so my pillow can lay against it.
And I got my flight buddy, so I really just wanted to be me and my flight buddy in a row. So I'm going to pay for a seat because I don't want a 3-seater. I wanted to be just and my flight buddy. Sitting right next to me.
Are you calling me a flight buddy?
Yeah.
It's a flight buddy.
But you're going to be on the outside. I'm going to be on the inside.
Definitely going to be on the outside.
You know. We're going to talk. We're going to act like we're going to talk for the whole flight.
Yeah,
but
right,
then she's going to be out. She's going to be out and I'm going to be out at the same time.
First of all, we always be asleep because you always want to catch them early ass fucking flights.
Yo, dude. Definitely got to get the early
flights. I swear, we have never taken an afternoon flight out of here. Like,
I don't want to take an afternoon flight, but I need mine to be at least 9 o'clock.
I don't think we've ever taken
less than 6 o'clock.
I'm gonna meet y'all there.
When we went to Vegas, we had a 5 a.m. flight.
Yeah, I had an early ass flight.
We had to be at the airport at 3 o'clock in
that
the
was
morning.
Ridiculous. I was like, yeah.
But that's
my flight at 11.
By the time you got there, we was so drunk.
But that's my normal time of getting up too, though.
We were so drunk.
Yours
too, yeah.
But I don't like to get up that early for flights. Like, I don't like to get up there early for work. So I'm really not like.
You know what?
Like, we got to get early, so we had a whole day. Like,
that's my mindset.
But
like,
we be drunk as fuck by 12 o'clock.
Right. You get drunk early, take a nap, and you can go back and re-attack it all again.
We don't never take a nap. We just be up and drunk.
Up and gone.
Or you can be up and gone, and you just
we might come back in the shower and change.
Drunker,
I hate being too tired for nighttime.
Is drunker a word?
Drunker, yeah,
drunker.
Right?
Or is it more drunk?
More drunk.
Oh, is it more drunk?
I think it's more drunk.
Well, but drunk, I like drunk is.
You could use whatever
I like drunker better.
But drunkest is a word, because you're the drunkest person there, so why wouldn't drunker be a word?
Even if it's not, I like drunker. I want to be drunker.
I'm finna Google it.
or even drunkest.
To Vegas, we was
y'all was turned
so drunk so loud, and she was laughing at us. I was looking at the videos the other day.
Oh, he is drunk.
She was like, "Oh my god, you so drunk!"
And I'm like, 12 o'clock
But we had been there since 6
We got there at 11 Y'all was so drunk.
First of all, when she called
at 12 o'clock
we was on the phone. She was like,
"I'm like, where y'all at?"
You was like, "Yeah, we just gonna get an Uber because are you drunk?" I was like, "As fuck."
Yeah, y'all was drunk. So, Vegas so fun. We got to redo that trip.
Drunker is a word, by the way.
Drunker.
Affected by alcohol to the extent of losing control of one's faculties or behavior.
Faculties.
Right.
Oh, wait. Interesting.
That mean you boo booed on yourself?
Oh, no. Oh, no.
Drunker. According to Wiktionary, the comparative form of drunk is drunker.
Okay, cool.
And the superlative from being the drunkest.
Yikes.
See, I told you, I'm like, if drunk is the word, drunker has to be a word. Yeah. I am now drunker than I was before, and I plan to be the drunkest ever by the end of the night.
And my nickname will be Drunky because I think. Come here, Drunky.
Oh, no.
All right. So.
Now we got that out the way.
Got that out the way.
I wouldn't have been able to rest until I found out.
Oh, yeah, we know that. We know that. All right. So, you know, of course, as we always do, we give tangible information. That's what we do, right? So I got a question. Hmm? How do you handle being used by by a loved one, right? So, for example, a son or a parent or even, you know, cousins can be, they can get X'd out. I'm okay with that. You know what I'm saying?
You said, how do you feel of what?
How do you feel when you realize that you're being used? How do you handle
used.
It? How do you handle that?
Oh, I cut people off.
I'm about to say BFF cut them. I've seen her do
they
it.
They be family friends. I don't get fucked with
with the scissors.
But, okay, so let me ask you, which family member, because you and your brother's really close.
Well, he the only one I probably would never cut off, though.
So, how would you
but
handle
anybody
it?
Else?
What type
even
of conversation?
Even I cut him off, too, sometimes. Just,
no, you just cuss him out and hang
out. Yeah, that's what it is. It's more of a cuss out. Never really a cut off.
You cuss him
it's
off.
It's a cuss out.
You true.
And
that's
I,
right.
And
you
I,
right.
Let you, I give you, I give you a
lying.
Day.
That's true.
I give you a day to really take that's in true. The cuss out that I gave you.
That's true. And it don't even ever be a day because we talk the next day.
Right.
I cuss you
it,
out and
it might be like the evening part of that day.
I'd be like, all right.
Well, unless he got cussed out in the evening. Dude, right. Just call her the next day after work.
Right. Yeah. So,
or text me.
So how do you handle that? How do you
he's
handle?
He's so used to it though. He be like, "Hey, sis."
Right.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's over.
We got that relationship for sure.
But how do you handle that? Like, if it was him, let's just put him in that category, right?
Mm-hmm.
Where you realize, like, man, I can't believe my brother using me for whatever the reason may be, right? And you, of course, you don't want to get him out of your life. That's your brother.
It's
been your best friend for years, right?
Yeah, I wouldn't.
But how would you, how would the conversation go when you realize? Because what happens, I think when people get used, they don't have this conversation. They just cut people off.
That's true.
You know what I'm saying? Some people, I think some people that's might be true. Wanted for the conversation, even if you still gonna cut them off afterward. But maybe the conversation can help them not use the next nigga that they finna.
I mean, I don't really give people conversations. I really just block you. But with him, it would be different. I don't. Right. Honestly, I really don't, honestly. Like, I was looking at my block list the other day, and it was like, I don't know, it was a lot of people on there. But for him, it would be different because, I mean, we do have a close bond. So I would try to figure out what happened. Like, I would ask him, like, okay, X, Y, and Z, why did you do this? And I mean, if I really didn't like the answer, if I felt like he was lying, I clearly know you were using me, like, I would have to just let that go. I mean, but if he was honest and said, okay, you know what I'm saying, this is what it was, I apologize, this is, you know, I was taking it a little too far, I should have did X, Y, and Z, then we can mend that relationship. But I can't stand a liar. Like, that's, for me, he's never lied to me, right?
Right.
So he'll leave out information, right? Which is, you know, to me,
that's a form of lying, but not like a flat out lie.
So we supposed to go shopping and you invite somebody else and don't tell me, that's not a lie, right? Because you just never told me.
Because he know you would have been like, how the fuck you not about to invite Pookie with us?
But if we went to the mall and you start using my card and you didn't tell me, now you and I say, you know, were you using my card? And you just said no. okay, you know, you cut off because I don't, that you lying. Right. And I can't, like, if I can't trust you, it's a wrap.
Yeah.
Like, it's very, y'all already know it's very few people we could trust.
Right.
Exactly.
So if you make that list, it's no coming back from it. And I would hate to lose that relationship, but I can't trust you. So.
I agree.
So I have to cut them ties. I would have to.
But you know, sometimes.
So once you realize. Hold on, wait. Once you realize that, right? Do you block him, cut him off, or whatever, mm-hmm. or do you tell him first, like, yo, because you're lying to me? Because
we're in a conversation. That would all be in that same conversation.
Okay. Yeah, I would tell like, you. Don't you ain't gotta call me no more.
Yeah, I would tell you in that conversation because it was him. But anybody else, I would probably just cut him off. Like, block. I'm straight.
Whatever.
I'm good.
I'll go ahead.
I think sometimes you have to address it because some people don't even realize that they're using you.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Like, some people's nature is just to be a certain way.
Mm-hmm.
So sometimes you have to be like, hey, it's just like, don't always invite me because you know I'm going to pay.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Or don't always come to my house because you know I'm going to make drinks. Mm-hmm. Or don't, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's stuff like that. But then when you notice, like, well, damn, you always want to come over here, but then I don't never,
mm-hmm.
when you hang out somewhere else, I'm never invited there.
It's like you fix people like that. For me, I'd be like, okay, well, bring a bottle or beer, bring something to bring. Like, I'm going to fix that if it's little shit.
Yeah.
It's the big shit for me.
Well, I'm just saying, that was just like an example. Yeah. Like, you know what I'm saying? People are, if you're always like, oh, let's invite such and such because you know they gonna pay. You know what I'm saying? Then you get the order and all crazy because you know bill on me because that's just my nature. Yeah. It's like, wait, whoa.
Yeah, I don't like people like that.
Yeah.
I don't like people like that.
But then it's like, because sometimes you have to notice like, well, damn, nobody ever pull their card out. I'm always the only one pull my card out. You know what I'm saying? Right. So then you got to start tabling things. Yeah. Like, okay, I'm not going out with y'all no more.
I was about to say, you start to distance yourself from that.
Because like for us, whoever pulled their card off first pay. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Or like one pay for lunch, one pay for dinner, one pay for drinks, one pay for, you know what I'm saying? Like we always pay for one another. So it's no tally counting.
Yeah.
That's another, that tally count shit, bitch, we not finna do that.
Right.
Like, well, last time I paid $35 and your bill was only $20, so you still
hold. So you got one more round? You got one more visit to the bank.
That's
because
that was one of my pet peeves. That was one of my pet peeves. That's the worst for me, I swear.
Oh, man. So
like,
what
do I hate to tell you?
Like, don't
you
got do
one,
that.
You got one more swipe visit.
A lot of times I can't even tell you how much the bill was. Mm-hmm. We just paid that motherfucker and went on about our lives.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Like, somebody at the paint thing was like, how much did all of this cost? I'm like, I don't know. Like, we just pay and keep it going.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Like, whatever. But yeah, that's
how it is with, I mean, that's how it is with our group, but sometimes I have to realize like other people are not like that
because they're not programmed that way.
And I just be wanting to cut them off though.
That's why that one is a minus one.
Yes,
right.
It's like
minus one.
Like,
so like our friends list is very short. Do you have a friend whose house you've never been over?
Like been a real over friend?
Here? Yeah.
How's it a friend if you've never been over their house?
I don't know. I'm about to let me make this call real quick. Let me see if he answered his phone. But because
No, that don't even. That's, how's that your friend?
He ain't shit.
I'm like, wait. First of all, I only got a handful, so.
Please leave your message.
Nope.
Nope.
I don't even know why you call him. Not only ain't you never been in his house, he don't never answer the phone when you call him. Is he really a friend?
I was about to ask that question.
It's not a friend.
But see, the funny thing is I don't even deal with him anymore because I feel like they're not friends.
That's not a friend.
I feel like when you reflect on stuff, it'd be like, damn, I've always been a friend to you, but you've never been a friend to me.
Yeah, I was about to ask
and
that question.
And that's that comfortable because it's like you so used to like what y'all had. You don't even think about like I've never been to his house. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
but you know what?
I can think about.
You know,
that.
I was
but
about to put him on.
That's like you say like about exposure, right?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. When you get exposed to something, like you get exposed to a true friendship, you be like, bro, me and you wasn't ever even cool.
Ever.
You know what I'm saying? Like. Which is something that I had to learn.
That's a hard lesson to learn. But that's what made me say you can't use the word friend loosely.
Yeah. It don't matter if we know the motherfucker 20 years.
Yeah.
You just know somebody 20 years.
You're not a friend. You know what I'm saying?
You can't. They not friends. Like, you can't use it loosely. Cause
I feel like sometimes you can grow out of friendship, right? But,
oh, yeah.
But you never put it in perspective that you grew out of this friendship.
Yeah. I mean, was it really a friendship, though?
But... And it could have been a friendship based off of anything. You could have had a trauma trauma bond friendship.
You could have had a party in friendship. You could have had a drug abuse friendship. You could have had a,
like, they could have been there for you at one point in time. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, let's say you go through a hard time in life.
Just because somebody beat her for you don't mean they're your friends, though. So what I'm saying. Were they really your friends, though?
What's the classification? What makes you the friend?
I mean, it's a lot. It's the history for me. Like, you can know, like you said, you can know somebody for 20 years, but y'all just talked on the phone. Like, or y'all never did anything together. Mm-hmm. Y'all never. I mean, I wouldn't say that was a friend. I would just say that was a close person to me. Yeah. You know what I mean? Right. Like, friend is like us. We do stuff together all the time. We go to our kids' events. We celebrate holidays. Like, we do shit together all the time. I see y'all down there fucking several times a week. Like, definitely. Talk all the time. Yeah. Like, that's friends. Like,
and that's to switch over a little bit.
But I see what you're saying, like, outgrowing friendship. Like, but it's hard, though, because it's like, I got a friend that we have been friends for since we was 15? Mm-hmm. And it's so hard for me not to look at him as a friend because I love him so much. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying?
Right. Yeah.
So do I know that we're not even friends anymore? Yes. Mm-hmm. Mentally, can I accept it? No.
No. Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And I think
because if he was to call me right now, I'm going to answer the phone. You know what I'm saying? If he needed me right now, I'm going to be there. But on the flip side, if I call him, he's not going to answer.
Yeah.
And it's been plenty of times I needed him and he wasn't there.
Yeah.
And that's,
you know what I'm saying? So it's like a one-sided friendship.
That's true.
You know what's crazy?
But it's hard for me.
That was a real friendship, though.
Yeah, I see people who do that. Yeah, that was a real friendship. I see people do that in relationship, too, though.
Yeah.
Like, they like, do I know this nigga's not good for me or this chick is not good for me? Mm-hmm. Yes.
Yeah. Yes.
But am I going to be there for this person when they need me? Yes.
Unfortunately.
I'm still going to be there. I'm still going to do my thing. Because
it's toxicity, though.
Because it what is. Happens
it's
is.
Toxicity. It is. You can have a toxic friendship as well as a relationship.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I think it's a combination of you remembering how y'all started
was.
Out.
Yep.
And that's you still see falsifications of the future of how y'all could be.
Yep. Mm-hmm. And it's like you don't want to walk away from the. What could happen? Shout you know what I'm saying? Like,
shout out to me for using falsifications like that.
I like that. Let's go. But it's like you said, like, I think about, like, being lost in a school, not knowing where I was going or nothing, and him being the one like, hey, don't you live down the street from me? Come here, let me show you. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's how our friendship even started. Mm-hmm. And then next thing we know, we was catching a bus home together. We was always together talking, laughing, joking, but it was never no, like, I like you type thing. Mm-hmm. It was always been a true, genuine friendship. Right. And then, like, me and his mom got close, and me and his sister got close, and then his sister started having kids, and then, you know what I'm saying? It was just like, he was family.
Mm-hmm.
And we was that way all the way up until he met his kid's mother.
Mm-hmm. You know what's crazy?
Yeah.
For a man, right? I know y'all don't understand this, but I'm going to tell y'all, for a man, we can see certain things. Mm-hmm. And I'm going to switch gear just a little bit. It's going to go a little left, but stick with me.
Oh, shit.
We can see certain things, right? And because we see it and we're not, and it's skipping past our brain, the dick might get hard.
Huh?
You hear me? Right? Go with me. Like, if you look at certain things.
Skip past your brain?
Yeah, it go past the brain. Like, it go from the eyes straight to the dick. It does not go to the brain, right?
Oh, my God.
But then there are certain things that you see where you can't look at it any other way than for what it is.
Mm-hmm.
And what I mean by that is, so I had somebody that asked me not too long ago, like, how do you not look at Kiki like that because she beautiful and she got a body and she got, and I'm like, that's because that's nasty.
Like, sure.
You know what I'm saying? I'm like, I don't know. That's nasty. Like,
no, I'm not like, that's nasty.
Yeah,
not you.
No. I'm like, yuck.
Ew.
You know what I'm saying?
Ew.
I'm like, it's the way they was looking at her, I can never see myself looking at her.
Yeah.
Like, and it's crazy because I never put it together like that. Because I'm like, it's been times I watch a show on TV, and I'd be like, why did you just get hard? I wasn't even thinking like that. You know what I'm saying?
If
you scoot past somebody, or if you get somebody a hug, or have no control over that.
Yeah.
That's why I'd be some men be like, well, am I gay? Because the dude skipped past me. He rubbed up against me. And I got to cover my.
Oh, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I remember the bouncers used to say
that. Like, they cover themselves because they don't want it to.
Oh, okay.
But
so they don't get.
Because
hard.
Because it don't go to the brain. It go from.
Remember, Smitty told me that he, like, an ass is an ass. Like, when you, like,
brush up against it.
Yes. Yeah, they don't
dick
know.
Don't know it's a man's right, ass. Right, right.
Like, because it skipped past the brain.
Right, you want to fight him because your dick got hard.
Right.
What the fuck?
Yeah. So, and it's crazy. And I don't know why I just thought about it in this capacity like this. But, like, I don't look at. It's just some things that you shouldn't.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? You don't look at. And so when you have those type of relationships, you do everything you can to make sure that they stay pure and, and they like you don't want to lose them relationships is what I'm saying, because there's certain there's some people you like. If you would have met Tupac, y'all probably wouldn't have been friends, because you would have been like, every time I look at him, I just want to get to him. I just want like, you know what I'm saying?
I would have gave him some cool.
You know what I'm saying? Like
Jada and
if I got to keep you away from my cousin because he kind of favored Jim Jones a little bit, because
that nigga
you might
do not look
at him
like
and,
Jim Jones to me. He like, so you like him? I'm like,
yeah, no.
He ugly to me.
I mean, and
Jim Jones? Oh, yo.
No.
Oh, I'm like, wait, Jim Jones?
You know, Jim Jones.
She don't. I don't think she like him no more though. But
no, her, she said no more.
Yeah. I still like him.
Oh, I was about to say. Like him. You still like that one? Hey, Jimmy, I'm gonna hit you up later, man. Got some business to take.
But you know what? That's because I love that thug mentality. Like, I just love how he snatched that nigga up. Like, apologize.
I love that. I love it too.
You know what's
that's why, but you know what? That's why I don't like Ryan no more. Because although he was once attractive to me, he a fucking crybaby.
Who?
Ryan from
Black Ink.
Yep. Chicago. Okay. Because why are you such a bitch?
Yeah.
You could never be my nigga. First of all, my mouth's too slick. You could never be my nigga.
He been wet since he got caught up with that girl.
I didn't like him even before that.
He been wet.
Like season two, I was like, bleh.
Hey, let me ask y'all, how do y'all
cute, but no, I could never
he's still handsome,
him.
But yeah, I'm not attracted to him.
I could
like,
never fuck
that's
with him.
That's one of the ones you be like, oh yeah, he cute, but
he
don't do it for
soft.
Me.
He way too soft. Like, he don't got no thug in him at all.
None.
So let me ask y'all this.
And you can't be trusted because you
fucked a liar.
And you fucked your best friend's girl. You can't be trusted.
So is it a red flag or is it okay? Like, how do y'all look at this? If a man can feel comfortable enough to compliment another man.
That's fine.
Men don't do that though.
They don't.
Only women do that.
I know, but
I mean, I heard of men.
Here's the thing, I do it.
You do, but that's why I'm saying it's okay.
So I want to know, am I a red flag?
No,
because like, I will.
We don't care.
I never question your sexuality. So
I'm not worried about that either. But
yeah, it's not a red flag for me.
I think red flags only matter
to those. I feel like it takes a real man to just be like, you look nice.
You look nice.
Yeah, you smell good, dog. What you wearing?
Nothing wrong with that. I don't think nothing wrong with that.
But a lot of men will not subject themselves to,
because they got the stigma of the gay though.
Men are like, so
they
homophobic.
Without they don't even knowing want it. Anybody feeling like they are. So if they
like, if a man tell another man he handsome, he probably want to fight.
Right.
Right.
Like, nigga,
which
why
is
you
sad to me?
Nigga, why you looking at me in the face? Well, we always be like, we tell a girl, they're like, oh my god, you are so pretty.
So
and
so
that's okay.
Quick. Like, so quick. All
they
the time.
Smile, like, oh, thank
I
you.
Always tell women when they're pretty.
The
like, you pretty, you smell good. You go on, Katie.
Oh, you got my drop?
Yeah, I got you.
Why you going hard, Katie?
Cause these hoes hate.
So, and I ask that because I do notice that men don't give men compliments.
No,
you know what
sure,
I'm saying?
Sure don't.
But me, I'm out here. I'm like,
you know how men compliment? Hey, bro, where you get them shoes from?
Them boys cold.
Them tight.
Mm-hmm. Them boys cold right there. Where you get them from?
Or, damn, that hoodie sweet. Where you get that from?
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Like, that's
instead of saying you look nice.
Instead of saying, like, you look nice.
You look nice.
Where you get that from? That's their compliment. And then men get on my nerves. Where you get that from? Oh, from around the way.
Right.
And they never gonna tell you.
Bitch, I will Google it.
Hey, this.
But women do the same thing. They never tell you where they get stuff from.
That's like, how men compliment you.
Because I never know, though. When people ask me, I never remember.
BFF be like,
because I shop too much. Sometimes.
It was in my closet. Where you get that from? My closet.
I have no idea.
That's how men compliment other men on like their haircuts and stuff like that. Oh, this nigga got a haircut right there. Look, okay, I see you.
I see you. That's it. Thank you. That's how you know it's a compliment, right?
Right.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Appreciate that. Yep.
Yeah, appreciate you.
Mm-hmm.
That's right.
Wait, speaking of haircuts, let me tell y'all something that I will never forget in 5,000 years, right? One day we was at Kiki O house.
Uh-oh.
I think I was pregnant with Taz. But we had left getting our nails done.
Mm-hmm.
And we got home and her ex-husband was sitting on the couch. This nigga turned on the whole light because he got his whole face cut off.
Oh yeah, I remember that day.
Oh yeah.
First of all, so we sat down on the couch. He was on the big couch, we was on the little couch. We talking, we laughing, whatever. So she look over. Okay, babe, I'm gonna wait.
Oh.
So she look over.
I'm out of simple air. I'm sorry.
She did like a double take. Then this nigga turned the light on, turned the other light on, and said, "The fuck you do that for?"
Yeah, I don't like it.
She was like, he was like, "You don't like it?" She was like, "Absolutely not. Don't ever fucking do that again." He was like, "It's gonna grow back." He looked so weird.
Yeah, he
like,
did.
It's gonna grow like back in 2 weeks.
He cut
like a pedophile.
He did. Yeah, pedophile. She was like, "You look like a rapist, like a pedophile or something."
If I didn't meet you with a pussy face, I don't expect to ever see you with a pussy face, because I don't trust you after that. You know what I'm saying? A man that'll cut his face off is
really
untrustable.
I can't say too much because I did cut my hair off. So I mean, I did the same.
Your facial hair?
No, remember she came home with that vibe.
I cut my hair all the way
y'all
down.
Yeah, remember when she came home with that vibe?
Mm-hmm.
And we was all like, "The fuck?"
Right, she's like, "It's gonna grow back." And that's what he said.
That's what he said.
He did. That's what he said.
That's what he said.
He did. That's what he said.
He did use it back on you, though, didn't he?
He did.
It's gonna grow back.
Yeah, but that was like tore.
You was like,
"Mine was cute."
You was like, "When? When is gonna grow back?"
Her up.
She never did it again, though.
Her up.
Mm-mm. You never did it again. Mm-mm. You was like, "I can't even put my hair in a ponytail or nothing."
I hate it because I think I got extensions, right?
You
like
did.
2 weeks later, because I was like, "I missed my hair."
You was like, "Why did I do it?" Wasn't it right after you had Xavier?
Yes.
I like colored you had it like that moment. It.
Yeah.
You sent me the picture. I was like, "I know that's a weave."
I know.
She
was I know you lying.
Floor. I was like, "Oh, my hair."
She like, "No, I had cut it."
But it grew. It kept growing back.
I was like, "I'm going to fuck Paige up." Because why she do that?
All but KD be doing that too, though. But I was like, "Listen, you want to cut your hair? Get a weave."
Yeah. It grew back weave. So fast.
I did that for
get
my
the sew-in, boy. Yeah, get the sew-in, boy. Because you might not like it. If you like it that much, then you could.
It grew back so quick.
I didn't like it, though.
Yeah.
Because you gotta always do something to it. Like, I'm very much a bun girl.
Yeah.
Like, that shit didn't fit in the bun.
No.
You said bun girl?
A bun girl.
I thought she said fun girl.
Bun.
Because she fun girl.
Yeah, I bet say she fun. Yeah, with the bun.
That's what you said. Yeah, he called it a joystick.
Yeah.
That's true.
Like, yeah, you gotta control it. Controller.
I be Mrs. Pac-Man. Gobble, 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 gobble. Uh-huh.
Okay. I was thinking the other way.
What?
From the back.
Oh, that's
I was thinking
that
way.
Yeah.
But so you did this. But you did this.
That's
I was
when I'm
like,
sucking
oh,
his
no, that
dick.
Ain't from the back.
That's when I'm sucking his
I,
dick.
Yeah, I figured
gobble,
that.
Gobble,
I
gobble,
had gathered.
Gobble, gobble.
I gathered it.
But then when he hit me from the back, he's like,
wow. I like that part. I put my hair in the ponytail specifically for that.
Gone,
and be down all the time. Because I like to, when I be on top, I like to like bounce my hair and shit. Like I'm
on the
corner.
And then when it's time for the bag, I be putting that bitch up like, oh no, it's this time, nah. I be a whole hairstylist, like, bitch, you can't fuck with me. I be fucking hairstylist today. Okay, at the beauty salon today.
Yeah, and I'm about to give y'all a commercial right now, just off the top of the dome. For the Simply Ellis Face Meal. Can't breathe? Just get Simply Air. All you got to do is go to
I'm like, what the
whatever,
fuck?
MBON.com and click in /Simply Air if you want the Simply Air. I'm just playing. It's not on there yet, but we are going to.
That's going to be good.
/Simply Air is what you need, man.
It's not like you're having a hard time breathing.
Yeah, because I can't breathe. You need the Simply Air, man. But we are going to pay some bills real quick, man. What's up? So,
did somebody say fragrance? Well, let's get into our first sponsor for the day. The first sponsor for the day is Preeminence. Preeminence is the top fragrance on the planet. Listen, the top selling fragrance for Preeminence is Orgasm, and it's in a newly designed bottle. This bottle is fantastic. I'm talking about, if you don't even get it for the fragrance, the bottle is enough. Listen, to get Preeminence, all you have to do is go to theperfectperfume.com. I said it, you heard it. Theperfectperfume.com. And what you do is you go to the promo code and you hit reality20 and get yourself 20% off of your final order. Now, what they have is they have an organic fragrance. Like, it's all natural oils, so it lasts longer on your body. It's a must-have. Listen, again, theperfectperfume.com. Use the promo code Reality20 so he'll know where you came from, and you get yourself an extra 20% off of your order. So go. What you waiting on? Go to Preeminence right now. ThePerfectPerfume.com. Come on, let's go.
Let's get it. So
let's go.
I'm mad because I seen something earlier I wanted to bring to the show, but I could not find it right now. But aww, it was talking about...
That's why you got to screenshot it.
I know, right? I it was talking about 90s, like 90s baby. Like any 90s babies that got bad knees. Mm. It was like, this is why.
They don't got Megan knees, huh?
And it was like... Because in the 90s, you was doing the Tootsie Roll. You was doing the butterfly.
You was doing the Tootsie Roll.
Everybody was doing the percolator and all that other stuff.
Time for the percolator.
The crybaby, yep. So,
I ain't got nothing to do with knees.
The crybaby? Oh, that's when you get on the ground.
Yeah.
Yeah,
but you
got to get down first, and then you got to... I guess you got to add the snake to it. You know what I'm saying? Because you were snaking all the way down. That might be bad.
I mean, that was in our days, though. We did all of them. Okay, first of all. So, and we still got good knees, okay?
Right now, but Kiki, you 21.
I know.
I know. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, when you get older, it's crazy because that was
happening. I mean, nobody going to have good knees when they get older.
Look, so. this is when you know you're
old. We ain't worried about that right now.
I'm having a conversation with Katie's dad. And mm-hmm. we both talking about back in our day. I said, mm-hmm. this something. I didn't turn into a back in my day nigga already.
All the time.
I didn't turn into a back in the day nigga. Boy, I tell you.
When I be talking to Leonard, I say that all the time.
Right. Like, back in my day.
Back in the day. I'm like, back in the day.
Pop was talking about football. He was talking about when they had the one strap on the face. And he was like, yeah, the Lions won back in the 50s.
In the 50s?
Like, I said, they won what? They ain't never won no Super Bowl. He was like, no, ain't not Super Bowl. They had different championships back then. I was like, oh yeah, you're right. I remember that. I don't remember like I was there. I remember like I did history and
right.
And,
you know? Yeah. That's a long time ago.
I'm like, man. So I do want to breeze over this next situation real quick. I don't want to go too far away. Mm-hmm. It didn't just happen, it happened a while ago. But the whole Travis Scott thing. You been keeping up with that?
The concert?
Yeah, the Astro World. Mm-hmm. I almost said Astro Glide. Anybody who's a freak know what that is. you been keeping up with that? What you think about that? Do you think so now? And the mean, what I mean by that is, like, a lot of companies now is canceling him.
I mean, he should have expected that because that's what they do with everybody that has some type of controversial, like,
situation
now. They try to cancel you. I think he gonna be okay. I don't feel like he did nothing wrong. Like, I mean, it wasn't like he did it. Like, it's something that happened. So what's the problem with them? They think he should have stopped the concert?
They saying he should have stopped the concert because he let the concert go for so many minutes afterwards.
Okay.
And he didn't stop it.
So did he know exactly what was going on while he was doing the concert, though?
So when he just recently did an interview with Charlamagne, and he said he didn't know.
I figured, because if you on stage rapping, how do you know what's going on in the audience?
And what people don't understand, if you're not a performer of any type on the stage... if you're on the stage, you have lights in your face.
Yeah.
And some people who perform are nervous still, no matter how long you've been doing it. So you need those lights because you don't want to really focus.
He focused on his craft. You focus on
your next move and your steps and what you're going to say. You're not focused on like
the words. Who's like saying it's so much they have to worry about besides like what's going on. All they probably see is the people bouncing and, you know, singing to the song. They probably don't see like the little stuff or somebody passing out or you know what I'm saying? What's going on? They probably couldn't see that. So.
And think about back when like Michael Jackson was doing his thing, right? Mm-hmm. People was passing out just because they was in his presence. Mm-hmm. You know how many times he would have had to stop the show?
Yeah.
Because somebody passed. Now, if they were stepping on the person who passed out, then I would kind of hope that somebody would at least surround the area and try to block it off until whatever. But I don't think... Honestly,
I don't feel like he did nothing wrong.
Yeah, I don't think he did nothing wrong.
I don't think he should be canceled for that. Like, honestly, I mean, and he gets sued and everything. Like, I mean, it's going crazy with it. But I mean,
a lot of people don't agree with
the suing part. Probably with the people that died, I probably would sue. Honestly,
but
if it was me, but my child died at the concert, I would probably sue. But as far as canceling him, I really don't understand that part. I was like, what?
But see, that's the thing though, and I don't know how correct I am when saying this part. Mm-hmm. But I don't think it was his show. I just think he was the headliner.
That's true.
You know what I'm saying? Mm. So if you're the headliner, you can't sue the headliner. You have to sue whoever's running the show.
So it was Astro World's show.
Right.
And it was several other performers
But you know, when you sue, you don't sue one person. You sue everybody.
Yeah, you sue separately, man, collectively.
Yeah, you suing everybody. You suing the venue, one stick. You're going to get out of it.
It's just like charges.
You're suing everybody.
Yeah,
you
I'm throwing 50 charges at you just to make sure something sticks.
And you know they're going
to
settle.
You sue them individually and collectively. Mm-hmm. But at the end of the day, this is the amount of money that I want to end up with.
Yeah, they're going to settle.
They're trying to settle.
Yeah, they're going to settle it. Because, but, I mean, they know some people died. They died at your venue. A lot of people. Yeah. So you're going to settle.
I personally feel like it's the venue's fault.
Yeah.
And the reason why I say that is because you are in charge of how many people are supposed to be here. Yeah. They said it was significantly overcrowded.
But you know how that
and
happened,
though,
right?
And where was the security?
Right?
Like,
so what happened was...
they didn't step in soon enough for some reason.
They picked the wrong security, which is why whoever was in charge of that, which had to be the company, they picked the... because people was climbing over the wall. It wasn't like they sold too many tickets and people came in. People were climbing over the wall.
So that's security. Somebody came from the water.
Yeah, did you see the video?
Are you serious?
Somebody came from the water.
Oh, yeah.
So you know, like the Aretha Franklin thingy we got.
Yeah.
It used to be Shane Park or whatever, right? Mm-hmm. So you know how the boats can watch the concerts.
Mm-hmm.
It was people who had the boats and they were actually pulling their boats closer to the stage and they were coming in, going under the stage. You know what I'm saying?
Okay,
so
okay.
I feel like that's when you go to Aretha Franklin, it's guards right there, right? Mm-hmm. You're not bringing your boat over here.
Yeah.
You're going to watch this shit from your boat.
Yeah.
And if you get if you get too close, they're going to be the National, not National Guard. Who's the people on the water? Coast Guard.
Coast Guard is going to be,
skirt, what you doing?
I need y'all to back up.
You know what I'm saying? So, like you said, they didn't take the proper precautions because you put all these people in danger.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? And then, also, I don't remember what podcast I was listening to, but they also brought up the fact that sometimes you're there like 2-3 hours before the concert even starts, right?
Yeah. Yeah.
So now you dehydrated, your knees are locking.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Then like you passing out. Like the 9-year-old who got killed actually fell from his dad's shoulders.
Right.
Because his dad passed out.
Oh.
From being there so long.
Mm-hmm. Hot and hydrated.
Yeah.
Dehydrated.
So he passed out and they trampled over the little boy.
Mm.
You know what I'm saying? Like to me it's crazy. Which, because they were like, well, they weren't helping people up. Well, one man actually died trying to help his fiance up.
Mm-hmm.
So now they both dead.
Mm-hmm.
Like you know what I'm saying? So you can't really stop to help because it's a stampede, right?
Yeah.
I mean, I don't feel, and then too.
That was just insane. People were just insane because what are you doing?
Why are you trampling over people? Where are you going? No, it's no fire.
That's
it's nobody shooting.
I didn't get
That's
it. I was like,
right
what
there.
The fuck is going on?
And then
on
he
here?
Tried so hard to make it right. Like,
I just didn't
he
get
was
it.
Paying for funerals.
Sure was.
Like, he was.
Yeah, he didn't have to do none of that.
So many people.
They didn't accept
and you know
it,
what's crazy? Some
oh, they
people
did.
Some
they
people did.
The lawyers told them not to accept
some
it.
Some
yeah.
people did yeah. accept it. But a lot of people didn't because it's like, if you accept this,
they're going to sue.
Then
you can't sue.
You can't sue.
Yeah.
Right.
So it's like, oh no, don't accept it because we're gonna get $1 million. Mm-hmm. So fuck this little $12,000 that you're gonna get because he was saying you can have whatever funeral you want. You can have dubs. You can have horse and carriage. You can have shit, fireworks. You know what I'm saying? He was willing to pay whatever.
But they probably like, no, that's not enough because we're gonna get.
But you know what they did?
The
you know those
money.
Lawyers used that against him
because for bribery.
They said him paying for the funeral was acceptance of his wrong.
Mm.
So you should not bribery, but it's saying like, I think this is my fault, so let me make it right.
Mm.
So they use that against him.
Mm. All right. So no, that's true. I'm sorry. I always look ahead when we're doing our thing.
Oh, like, he over there giggling.
Yeah. Yeah. Because I won't try to get ready.
You ever laugh in an inappropriate moment?
All the time.
Oh, because that was it. He like.
I done laughed at inappropriate moment. I done fell asleep at inappropriate moment.
I didn't fall asleep. We be in a whole ass conversation.
Conversation.
You knocked out.
I done been in meetings with people and fall asleep. They're like, well, let me finish up because I see DT. I'm a little sleepy. I'm like, thank you.
That's why I be scared when he got to leave work and go to a coaching. I'm like, babe, okay, well, can you take a nap? Because I do not want them people talking to you.
And you fall asleep.
And you fucking not out.
Because that's like, the rudest thing. Know, where they going to think you on drugs.
First of all, you in coaching, you, though. You the coach.
Yeah. But you know what, though? In my coaching, I'm so active.
No, that's because that's when you be coming up with these interactive.
Yeah, I'm about so to, active.
Make a fucking.
You have to, because you're going to fall asleep.
If you said that, that's too long, you're going to be.
And but you know, like, and I'm also I'm also writing it down.
He do not out also, though, like that bottom lip drop, and he be.
He be so like, tired. Bro,
you got the dope fiend nod, and you ain't never did dope
ever though.
I did.
When
that one time I walked out of the gas station. And that lady was smoking crack at the door, and I walked through the smoke. Remember, oh, I came home, God. And I said, babe, I might be a crackhead. Crack. Oh, yeah. I'm not sure if I am or not, but I might be a crackhead. Because she was in the open,
like,
smoking crack, and I walked through the smoke, and I said, oh, snap, I might be a crackhead. I'm not sure. I haven't stole nothing, so I don't think I am.
But the only dope you got is this pussy.
He indeed. Said, I never stole nothing, so I should
so I think I'm good.
Yeah, I'm not still a kind of crackhead.
I'm not dead.
Oh, my gosh.
You know what I'm saying? But, okay. All right, it's cool. So, and I was going to call it. So, I was having a conversation with my sister on that, on the whole astral world.
Oh, my God.
And she wanted to be involved in the conversation again. Here we but go. She don't know how to stop, but she's very entertaining. And I know Katie.
Was she on the other side? Well, they should have known.
Yeah, she's on. She's against.
They should have known.
She like, it was demonic.
It was demonic, and this was this. I said, no, you've been listening to too many people talk. Like, have you ever been to one of the shows? No, I haven't. I'm like, so how do you know? Have you ever been demonic? Like, I need to know how you recognize that something is demonic. God. Like, you gotta be it to recognize it. You know what I'm saying?
So,
like,
you know another thing they said. I don't know if you guys know.
Come on, it was a sacrifice. I said, but he already rich. What is he getting from your sacrifice?
Right.
First of all, he got two kids by Jenner. He good. She don't got to sacrifice shit.
First of all, she a billionaire.
She, you know what I'm saying? So,
she had to pay him child support.
Exactly. You know, they said that he used to do rave music.
Yeah.
So he do a lot of rave music. So they're saying that his music enticed the stampede.
Yeah.
No.
But that's like that's like if I listen.
Because rave music is just make you jump and do. So yeah. How do that make you run and stand and kill people? No, so, that's not the same thing.
You know what's crazy? Because I want to go to a rave. I don't want to do, you know, dope and anything that they say
you
that you have. I know. That's
so
what I'm saying.
Oh.
That's the point that I'm making. Like,
you've been to a rave before.
Yeah, I did a security at a rave before.
Yeah, I was going to say. Because back in the day. The
Times Square.
I just want to jump around.
At the apartment. Remember at the apartment?
Yeah.
The after hours on the third floor. Those were raves.
Man, you talking about fights, man? We had so many fights at the raves. I'm like, are you not high?
Because they drunk.
Whatever drug you got, it's not working.
But you know what'd be funny? Not to be like on a racist thing.
That's why I like weed.
When you put too many black people in a rave, it's gonna be a fight.
No, these weren't black people.
They was white people.
They was Chaldean.
Or them too.
They was scrapping. I'm talking
because
about.
The problem is you be high, right? And you be jumping and you be bumping.
Yep.
So if you off coke, right, and you jumping and bumping and I'm just drunk, I'm wanting to fight you.
Yeah.
Because why the fuck what is you bumping doing? Me? Yeah.
And that's the thing. So I guess each drug dude make, you know.
But you at a rave.
It was
Chaldean going to be jumping
it was
and bumping.
That's
Times Square.
Oh,
yeah.
I was talking about the apartment.
Yeah, so at Times Square is where we had like the majority of the fights, right? And it was so funny because the owner who hired everybody as security was the main one in the middle of the fights. Like, when somebody got into it, instead of him letting us put him out, now we trying to protect him because he in the middle of the fight, trying to throw everybody out too. And he was like 4.5 feet tall.
You know what? What?
So I'm like, bruh, go in there. Go. Ain't don't y'all got an office or something? Go in the office and just let us do our job out here. But my brother was like, yeah, just stand back and pick your part. Yeah, he's like, stand, either be first in line or last in line.
But
don't
the problem
be in the
with
middle
them is they finna shoot somebody, so I need you to just.
Yeah, that's why he just said. He said either be first in line or last in line. Don't be one of the ones in the middle.
Because you know our one homie, he gonna shoot.
Quick.
Everybody.
Quick.
First of all, if you get into an argument with him, you better not even put your hands in your pocket. Brain matter everywhere.
So let me ask y'all this question. Y'all ever been threatened before?
Like I'll beat your ass or some shit.
Like a real
like a
not a fight threat like a
life
threat like a life threatening type threat.
One time when I had said I was gonna give me a new nigga, you had did say you was gonna kill me.
No, I never thought I was gonna kill you. I said I was gonna sacrifice you in Illuminati.
No, you said you was gonna kill me.
I don't think I've
ever been directly threatened, but I feel like I've been in a threatening position before.
Same.
I hope Illuminati asked me for a sacrifice because I got one for him now.
That's not what you said. What you said was,
"How did you
get another nigga if you want to?" And I'm a kill you.
So how do you gauge when to take these threats serious?
I mean, clearly we got domestic violence situations all the time, so people don't know.
The verbiage of what somebody say make you be like, "Oh, this nigga here." Let me tell you what he said, girl. That's why I asked this question, because this is the second time I got approached with a cartel type situation. So if you're a fan of the show, then you heard the story that we told you before about my man. Like, I work with the cartel, and all I gotta do is call my cartel people. I'm gonna count down from 30, 29, 28. And so if you listen to the show, you heard that. And if you didn't hear it, then make sure you go back to listen to countdown from 30, because it was a countdown from 30, and it's very, very hilarious. But recently, and I feel like it was the wrong number, but I rarely take Facebook, Instagram, really text message, period. I don't take that stuff serious. I should, but I don't care. I don't do nothing. So maybe that's why I don't take it serious. But I had a dude, it was an out of country, I feel like, number, and it texts like, "Yo, my name is so and so from the cartel, and you know, you came across my path as if you was wasting time for me and my people. And I would hate to have to come holler at you and your family." He didn't say holler, but I'm giving y'all the American version. "I hate to have to come holler at you and your family." And I'm sitting here, you know, I never take anything serious. And I look at all of this type of stuff as an opportunity for a joke. So I'm like, "Let me tell you something." I'm texting back. "Let me tell you something. Jay don't play." Because if you know me, then you know my name, not Jay. Mm-hmm. But if you don't know me, you're like, "Listen, Jay." Like, but I'm like, he's like, "Listen, I'm from the cartel. My name is this." So I'm like, "Oh." I look up the name. The dude locked up. Been locked up for years. I'm like, "Man, get out of here with this thing, man." Shit. Right, get out of here. "If you pay me X amount of dollars, I'll make sure you and your family say." I mean, man, get out of here. You ain't know who my family is. You know what I'm saying? Go mess with Johnny and them over there and see. Because my family, Johnny, don't play. You know what I'm saying? But I say that to say I don't really know what threat to take serious and which one not to take serious. But I guarantee you this, don't start the conversation saying you from the cartel, because I'm not going to take it serious at all.
That sounds like some bullshit.
All right, pay me X amount of dollars. I said, "Oh, no, the scams are getting bad now."
Imagine how many people he actually getting money from, though.
Right. Man.
Ooh, the one situation I was in is when me and you were broken up. And we lived across the street from a house of, like, rowdy ass guys, and they must have noticed, like, that your car wasn't there no more or whatever. And I was going to back out the driveway, and they blocked my car in the driveway. And I called you first, but you were at work, you didn't answer. So then I called Black, and he was like, "Where you at?" I'm like, "At home." And he was like, "Okay." He's like, "Don't get out the car, don't move. I'm about to send my little brother over there. Give me 5 minutes." So he called me, he hung up, made a call, called me right back. So he like, "Stay on the phone with me, because I want to make sure, like, that they don't be on no, you know."
Yes.
Yeah. Because he was like, "They're trying to get you to get out the car. Don't get out the car." So I'm like, "Okay." So then I was like, "Oh my God, it's another car pulling up." It was like a black on black truck. Mm-hmm. And he was like, "No, that's my little brother. You're good." So the little brother knocked on the window, said whatever he said. The car pulled off so fast. Then he came up to my car. He knocked on the window. He said, "You good, Ma? Go ahead." So I'm like, so this guy with glasses just told me I was good. He like, "Yeah, that's my little brother." But I never had a problem.
And he called me right after that, too. Like,
because he was like, "You called Tay?" And I was like, he didn't answer the phone. And he was like, "Oh, no. Okay, I got it."
Yeah,
But I was so scared. I was crying because I didn't know. Like, they literally had blocked me in the driveway. And I'm like, and I was by myself. The kids was at school. Mm-hmm. I'm like, what? And then I'm like, have they been watching my house? Like, and then after that, they was like there when I got home from work. Like,
And we had the biggest house on the block, too.
Definitely had the biggest house on the block. So I didn't know what type of time they was on.
Granted, granted, it was in the Rough City area. And yes, it was only 8 houses on the block.
Oh, my goodness.
But we were the biggest of the 8.
And I used to be so drunk coming home from work. Like, one time I was so drunk that I went the wrong way on a service drive. Oh, and I woke up. That. Remember, I woke up. My car was pointed, like, to where I woke up in the car. Like, how? I was in the lot next to the tree, not even in the driveway. Like, how in the fuck did I do this? So then I was extra scared because I'm like, damn, they probably be seeing my drunk ass come home.
Right.
And that's why they started coming home with me. Like, we gonna make sure you good. Mm-hmm. But that was the only time I felt like I was ever in, like, danger.
Right.
Because normally I'm protected because I got you or I got the boys. I'm good. Mm-hmm. But I didn't have, I mean, they was babies. So
right,
fuck they was gonna do. I'm gonna tell my daddy on you.
Yeah, that's a dangerous tale right there. I'm telling you, that's a dangerous tale. All right, so let's jump into Ask KD. So for those who may not know, for whatever reason, Ask KD is a segment where you reach out to us, you kick it with us, you let us know what's going on. We got some tangible information for you. You know what I'm saying? You can hit us on any social media network. You can email us, you know what I'm saying, at relationshiprealitypodcast@gmail.com. You can call us at, psych, you can't call us. Just playing. Listen.
I was about to say, what?
But it's coming. It's coming.
We're working on it. I'm not.
We're working
on it. I got no phones to answer.
But, yeah, jump into the DM, you know what I'm saying? Holler at us. Let us know what's going on. Use the hashtag AskKD. We can follow on that as well to make sure to see what's going on. And I think we're going to change it for 2022. It might be a different hashtag. Because Ask KD is like very popular, and it's more of other folks than it is the people who we looking for, the realists. You know what I'm saying? So I'm gonna switch up some things for 2022, but we got a lot coming. Like we said, we give you that rundown before we get up out of here. But I got two. I got to give you two. I got three, but I'm gonna give you two today. Let's see here.
Oh my god,
love it. Have y'all ever gotten into it with like your significant other's people? Katie, don't answer that. I already know.
Yeah, I didn't get into it. This was just mean to me. Katie, don't answer that. I didn't say anything back.
No, I mean, you know, you had your little, not for real. Huh?
Okay, so here's what one of the realists said.
No, I seen BFF get into her ex significant other family. So right. I don't know.
But not like
I don't
that,
know why
though.
She said that.
Because I mean, not really get into it because I be respectful and I don't say how
true.
I really feel. So
that's
it's not really a get
oh, so
into.
You,
it's
so
just
you hold
a,
back.
That's
yeah,
true.
Yeah, because I don't want to be disrespectful. So
yeah, that's true. But all I done right. seen her put a motherfucker in a place expeditiously.
Mm,
you know how to spell that, bitch? What?
Expo. All right. So last Christmas, I struggled in the kitchen cooking for my fiance and his mom. I hear her talking junk about my food and yelling at me like she's Chef Ramsay. So, and she mean business because she didn't say junk, but I'm good at what I do. All right.
Shit.
Yeah.
Okay, we'll say the grown-up words.
All right. So.
Somewhat I'm good at what I do.
I got pissed and I threw a plate.
At his mama?
It cut her in the forehead.
Oh no, you took that too far.
Let's keep going.
Oh, no.
I got probation.
You got arrested.
Bitch, that's, I know you lying.
I know you fucking lying.
So here's where the help is needed.
It's no wedding.
Here's where the help is needed. I want my fiance back. Should I invite him over for Christmas this year? Why
no.
or why not? Like
no.
Why or why not? Is
no,
because no.
he was violent. Like that's you cross the line when you throw. That's assault. Like what the fuck? You whole ass assaulted.
Oh god.
Man, that was hilarious. She said, I threw a plate at her and cut her in the forehead.
No, that's too far because I would have probably broke up with you because you did too much.
Oh,
me.
She definitely got broke up with because she's saying she want him back. So, I can imagine how that story went. You bust my mom in the head with a plate.
Ain't no, I
it's
want you
over.
Back. I don't want you back. Like, you whole ass assaulted my mama. Like, what the fuck is wrong with you?
Hey, so, is it wrong to look at your mama like, oh, so she can throw a plate at you and get away with it, but you can always get whoopings? Like, so you gonna whoop me, but you ain't do nothing
my
to her.
God.
Okay.
I hate it.
Knew she was your favorite. Do it. So. Knew she was your favorite.
So this.
Katie, talk to me. What you got? Because I feel like you got a very relatable story coming behind this.
And do. So, so we were recently in a situation where my son's girlfriend got into it with my other son's girlfriend. So then my other son's girlfriend's mama came to my son's house and like threw grease on the wall, right? So now my other son's girlfriend, like, well, ex-girlfriend, oh, can we get back together? Like, I want to see you. And I'm like, never.
No.
KD broke up with her.
No. I mean, I probably
but I called her.
Right.
Okay, so
KD literally called her to break up with her. Look, no, it's not me, it's you. I think y'all heard this if y'all was listening to the show and followed through. You heard us talk about this a little bit.
I did call her because I feel like you got to understand that I'm serious.
I'm serious.
So I never want to see you again. Like, at the point where violence was chosen over common sense, this is done. So his mama was talking shit to you or about you or however, and you threw a plate at her? Girl.
Yeah. That's for me,
if
it's
you only knew what I've been through with my in-laws.
That's crossing the line for me.
Never would I ever.
No, I would never.
And I done been in some wow situations with my in-laws. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Like,
mine ain't been that bad, but I've been in situations where I could have popped off and did shit, and I chose not to say nothing and be disrespectful. Though? I mean, you know, I just chose to be respectful.
Yeah. Because you always got to choose respect.
Yeah.
Even if you pulled your fiance to the side, like, babe, like, she really is, like, stressing me out. Yeah. Like,
yeah, I agree.
You know what I'm saying? And then you got to let him handle his mind.
Yeah, I agree.
But you cut her forehead.
You took that too far. Like,
to the point where you got probation.
I'm never getting back with you.
No, you might as well. That's you know
rap.
What?
That's a wrap for me.
You got to chalk that up
as
a loss.
You took that too far.
And get you a new nigga.
Yeah, new nigga me, please.
Because that nigga...
New nigga her, please.
Is gone.
Yeah, no.
Never. What?
It's a rant for me.
Because you got to think about it, too. If he forgive you, how is mama going to look at him?
Exactly.
Because if a bitch hit me in the head with a plate...
That's so far.
And y'all get back together...
That's so far.
You not my son no more.
No.
What?
No. What?
You said what?
If one of my kids' girlfriends, fiance, whatever, hit me in my head
and I gotta get stitches and probation. And you get back with her.
And he like, oh, we back together? Oh no.
Don't ever come around. You're not my son no more. Don't ever come around.
I got four sons that quick.
Holidays.
So are you asking him to be secretive?
Huh?
Are you asking him to be secretive?
No, I'm asking him to say fuck that bitch and don't be back with her.
But if they decide to not say that,
you just can't come around.
You can't come around me.
You can't come around.
Y'all better not have kids.
I don't ever want to be around her again.
Because who got grandkids? Not me. You had baby with her? Bitch, you a lie.
So you gonna blame the kids?
I won't cut the kids off.
You can't fuck the kids off.
I won't cut the kids off.
No, because if you don't exist, your kids don't either.
That's just
so. Was it an accident?
That's just me.
Huh?
It
wasn't an accident.
It wasn't
an accident.
You threw the plate. That wasn't an accident.
But people be like, I threw the plate, but I didn't intend for it to hit you.
I just wanted to make a statement. You don't know where it was going to land.
You threw it at me.
Knowing it could have, though. So that's not
and
an
you
accident.
Cut me in the head.
That's not an accident.
So his mama probably got a scar forever. Forever, ever?
Yeah, I'm done with
you. First of all, that show your instability, though, because you got so mad at the words coming out her mouth that you threw a plate at her.
You threw a whole plate. And cut her.
That bitch broke upside her head. That's not funny.
I don't believe in violence, but somebody should have beat that ass.
And one of my kids would have beat her ass.
And somebody should have beat that ass.
My kids don't even hit girls, but she's got
no, hit. It ain't no
just
way.
Cut my mama head.
Yeah, it ain't no way.
And that's the thing. So, like, how do you?
I'm sorry.
So that's when something like that happened, right? Is there a way for forgiveness?
Mm-mm. Not for me. Not for that.
Katie?
I don't believe in violence. Like, once it go violent for me, it's a wrap.
Just because you forgive somebody don't mean you want them in your space again.
Yeah,
I ain't saying they got to be in your space. I'm just asking.
I mean, you can forgive her, but you'll never trust her again.
You can forgive.
No.
I'm just never going to forget that shit. Mm-mm. So
nope, because that's
not looking at you
me.
Sideways.
On your face.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
Because I was listening to a...
you took that too far.
It's crazy that this part came up because I didn't know it was going to go here. But, you know, I'm always listening to stuff, right?
Mm-hmm.
And one of the most... intelligent people that I think I've encountered across, not physically, like I don't know the dude physically, mm-hmm. but he's been in all our lives for years,
mm-hmm.
guaranteed. It's Will Smith.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
and he had said something recently that I heard, and I was like, that's deep. Right? And he was saying, like, forgiveness is the attribute of the strong. Mm-hmm. Right? He was saying. So, y'all want to hear what he was talking about?
You can't punish people for mistakes. You know, it's like
that wasn't a mistake.
You have to forgive people. And a big part of that, you know, is forgiving yourself. We don't forgive ourselves for stuff, and it makes it impossible for us to forgive other people. That last time with Daddy-O, I just learned what love is. Love is not punishing people and beating on them for what they did and hanging on to that trifling shit, you know, that they did to you. And it's like getting out of being a victim, you know. And Daddy-O and his death purified my heart in a way that I love life. Like, I love the opportunity to be better. I love the opportunity to work with people to find their way. And he helped me cultivate like an emotional invincibility. To love and to be loved is really all there is. And everything else needs to be set up to support that.
You know what I'm saying? So now, that touched me in a way because I live my life similar to that. You know what I'm saying? And I live my life similar to that, honestly, because of KD. And the reason why I say that is because with us being together as long as we have, I know that I put her through a lot, right? But yet and still, in 2021, going into 2022, when y'all hear this, it'll probably be 2022, I'm not sure.
But, not sure when it's going to drop.
But she don't necessarily, well, every now and then, but she don't treat me in a way where she don't show forgiveness. You know what I'm saying? Like, she treat me like nothing has ever happened.
Not every now and then, though.
You know what I'm saying?
Do me like that?
And so, with her being, with me knowing what we've been through, and her being able to treat me like nothing has ever happened, I look at myself like, how can I treat anybody any way different? So, like, when my kids go through stuff, if KD probably look at me, she, I don't think she never asked a question, but I never involve myself in that type of stuff no more. And it's because of what we've been through, and it's because of what my sisters and them taught me from what they went through, that I'm not going to involve myself in that type of behavior until you ask me a question. Like, you know what I'm saying? So I always let my kids know, if you have a question, if you're struggling with something, feel free. I'm open. Talk to me. But I'm not going to interject because you're not ready. You're enjoying it. This is entertainment for you. You know what I'm saying? So where I'm trying to give you a heartfelt message because I've been through some of this stuff, you're not taking it that way. You're taking it like, oh, okay, cool.
No, not your oldest son. Nobody ever on my side.
Yeah, but I mean, he hadn't still because he's not ready.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? When you ready, your spouse know you ready. You know what I'm saying? So certain things that you may have, they may have done to you before, they cut that off after so long because they're like, no, this nigga ready now. You know what I'm saying? I'm not about to, we used to play like this before, but we ain't gonna do that now. We used to argue like this before, but we ain't gonna, he ready now, he ain't on that. Because you, it's a certain feeling and in an environment that you just place around yourself where it shows. You know what I'm saying? So like, it's so many people who I should definitely not forgive. But I can sit in a room with you right now and I can come, you can call me and tell me you need help and I'll come help you out. You can tell me you finna get out the hospital, you need a ride, I'll come get you a ride. You can tell me you need me to help you clean your house, and I don't even do this type of stuff, but I'll come and clean your house for you. You know what I'm saying? Because of the relationship that we should have had, not the one that we had, but the relationship that we should have had, and me just respecting you as the figure of my life that you should have been, even even if you wasn't good at it.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Because what I realize is that there is no manual to show you how to be a dad, how to be a husband, how to be a mom, how to be an auntie, how to be an uncle, how to be whatever. So everybody's still learning on the job.
Oh, yeah.
Some of us just suck way more than others. That's the problem. So I'm not going to fault you for sucking way more than others. You know what I'm saying? Because I know how I want to be treated. I know how I want it to be treated.
Yeah.
So I know, like, I'm not going to accept it now that I'm grown. Mm-hmm. But I'm not going to fault you for how you did me when I was young and didn't know no better.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying?
As long as you see the effort, though, then you
That's
good.
The thing, right. Yeah. And then for me, I've learned to, I'm going to give you what I feel like you need mm-hmm. without any rebuttal or expectation for you to give something back to me.
Right. Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So, like, people like, when we hang out with Lamar, Lamar pay and he don't look for nobody to mm-hmm. pay for the next round. Mm-hmm. Yeah. He just do it because it's on his heart to
do
it.
Oh, yeah.
That's mm-hmm. true.
You know what I'm saying?
Oh, yeah.
So,
even when I was cussing him out.
Yeah, like, when you see people like that.
I
he always do that. That's just him, though.
Yeah, he learned something along the way.
Yeah.
Somebody instilled something in him that stuck.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And he's like, I like this. I'm going to do
dad.
This. Right.
My dad.
And that's,
he got that from my dad.
And you can't, you got to enjoy that. You got to be, mm-hmm. you got to immerse yourself in people like that.
Mm-hmm.
But I also told him, be careful who you hang around.
Yeah.
Though, because
people use him, though.
Don't always get invited people, because you're always going to pay.
People use him. And I told him that. I said, in reality, like, who are your real friends?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Because people are around because you are so giving.
But this is the thing, though. For people like him, and I know it because I do it too.
He give and protecting.
He give and protecting.
Y'all the same person.
Yes.
He just younger.
Yes.
This is why I know.
Yes.
Because when we do this type of stuff, mm-hmm. we don't care if you're using this. We doing it to show.
Yeah, but he gotta be careful though. Like, you understand because you older, so you need to instill in him what you know. Because some of the stuff he doing, he don't know what some of the consequences are.
Yeah, so like
he pay attention to who using him and who, like, what's going on in his environment though. You know what I'm saying?
And that's why
he
like
not paying attention.
And I asked a question earlier. We was talking about, you know, people using whoever,
yeah.
right?
Yeah.
I honestly feel like when somebody using you or somebody using me, it's not up to us.
Yeah.
Like, we have a job to do with this person, right? Mm-hmm. I'm supposed to instill and show this person something. Mm-hmm. Whether or not they pick it up in the time span that they have us in their lives.
I just don't want him to get them. Hurt is my thing.
Because
he's so oblivious to, like, what's going on. Like, he don't pay attention. He just spend because he like to give.
Yeah. Right.
And then in reality, people looking at you like, oh, you got money. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
His girl said
he
that.
He got to pay attention. He don't pay attention to that part. It's like people watching what you're doing. It's always somebody watching.
You gotta be
careful of that. Like, you know it, right? He mm-hmm. don't know that part yet.
And the funny thing is,
he don't know that part. He's just giving.
And I reached out to him after that day, right?
Mm-hmm.
And I told him, I said, listen, because we are the same person.
Yes.
And the problem that we have is that we spend so much of our time trying to help those who need help.
Mm-hmm.
We spend so much of our time trying to motivate and inspire those who need to be inspired. But we have people who inspire us and want to help us that we don't spend enough time with.
Mm-hmm.
So what we're doing is we're capping off our own lives.
Yeah. Mm.
Because we can't go that far, because if we go too far, we're so used to helping the people that's beneath us or on our same level that you can't reach too far down. So you got to stay mm-hmm. there. You know what I'm saying? So you'll never get to another level until you can realize I can help some. But I got to realize who need help
mm-hmm.
and who won't help.
Yeah.
Because you might need help,
mm-hmm.
but you might not want help.
Mm-hmm.
Like we learned when we was, you know, feeding the homeless in Ann Arbor.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
They need help.
Yeah.
But they don't want help.
Exactly.
So we wasting time at that point.
It's just ungrateful people.
That's the conversation I had with my sister yesterday. Yeah. I said, because she be in situations where she need help, but because she feel like she depended on us for so long that she won't ask for help.
Yeah.
And I had to have a conversation with her. I'm like, mm-hmm. don't ever go without because you are embarrassed about what the past had for you.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
I don't care what I did for you mm-hmm. back in 2000 or mm-hmm. whatever. I'm your sister. Mm-hmm. If you need something, mm-hmm. call me.
You got to say
it. If these kids need something,
You got to
call
say it.
Me.
Mm-hmm. Right.
And she like, no, because you and brother, y'all done did so much. Mm-hmm. Da, 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 da. Mm-hmm. Like, even with the situation that we just had with her, I'm like, why are you giving her things she shouldn't have when you can call us and we'll make it okay?
Mm-hmm.
Right. It's not a lot of money.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? It's expensive, but it's not a lot of money.
Mm-hmm.
So you have to be able to say, hey, can you do this for me really
mm-hmm.
quick?
Mm-hmm.
And we'll do it.
Yeah.
It's not a problem.
Yeah.
Right. And if I can't do it, I can make a phone call to somebody who can do it.
Mm-hmm. But you know what?
Because I call Kiki in a minute.
People don't like asking for help, though.
I think that
comes
from...
And that's how she is. Because the problem. She feel like we've given her so much help
already
that she's tapped out on her help.
Yeah.
But I'm telling her...
It never runs out,
but that
though.
Shows that you are appreciative of everything we've done. Right. Mm-hmm. Appreciation is way more important than payback.
Yeah.
Right? Mm-hmm. Because you don't expect it. Appreciation means that I really truly appreciate what you've done. Mm-hmm. Not like, oh no, you supposed to do that.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Because expectation will get you cut off.
Quick.
Where appreciation will get you further.
And
forever.
That's the part that I like about, like, whether you are spiritual, whatever your spiritual belief is, right? I like to read all the Bibles and the Qurans and all that. Because I like the stories that it gives, because they give you a very good perspective of life, really. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? So I like the story of, like, when God was saying, you know, give 10% or whatever. Mm-hmm. But he was excited about the broke nigga giving him a dollar.
Mm.
More than the millionaire giving $10,000. You know what I'm saying?
Yes.
Because he was like, they get it.
Mm-hmm.
And so I took that concept, even though so many people misuse the concept of what it is.
Yeah.
And they try to leave out some parts, you know what I'm saying, so it worked for them.
Yeah.
But I took that concept and said, no, that just means give what you can. Mm-hmm. Help where you can.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? And so the part that I love about my sister, her sister, my sister.
Yeah.
You know, I stole
our sister.
Our sister, but I stole it.
All of our sister.
All
I
of
stole
our
it because that's my sister, too.
Right. But the part that I love about it is I remember years ago, because we did help in the raising of her second part of her life, right?
Mm-hmm. We did.
But I had a conversation with her, and I said, listen, don't ask us to do it.
Mm-hmm.
Ask us to help you.
Thank you.
Yep.
That's that part. You
know what I'm saying?
Put your part in, and I'll help you do your part. Yeah.
Because there's so many people who are just standing there and stick their thumb out and expect you to pick them up and take them to where they're going.
Yep.
No. I feel like I can only help you if you help yourself.
Yeah. Exactly.
You know what I mean? You got to do your part.
And I always give the story.
I'm not doing it for you. Like, we're not kids no more. We're adults. So you got to do your
part.
And I don't mind helping.
I love helping.
You have to do your part.
Yeah, because...
Don't tell me my rent $1,000. Can you give me $1,000?
All of it. Like, you don't have nothing.
I can get what you got.
Mm-hmm.
At least say, my rent $1,000. Can you give me $950?
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
You got to have something.
You know, my rent $1,000. Can you give me $999? I mean...
something.
Yeah. You know, like... You know, $999? Like,
anything.
No, nigga.
You gotta get something.
Get out and get it.
Right.
And then
ask me for what you need.
Ask me for what you need left.
Like, so my thing was the example that I always talked to her about when I talked to her back in the day, and I know she got it because of the story that Katie just said, is living proof too. But if your car breaks down on the freeway and you sit in your car, who's gonna stop and help you? Nobody.
Because
they don't know you need help.
Nope.
They just think you pulled over. Yeah.
But if you
making a call.
But if your car stopped on the freeway and you get out, you got your hood popped. You looking confused, like you're trying to figure out. You got your hazards on. Mm-hmm. You looking trying to figure out what's next. Like, how can I fix it? You're gonna get 30 people that come
over.
Yeah.
People gonna pull over for you.
If you run out of gas and you sit there, you just gonna be ran out of gas.
Because nobody know.
But if you out and you looking like you trying to push the car, you trying to figure out how to get to the gas station.
Or you walking up,
or you walking up the freeway with a gas can, somebody will pull to you and help you get to what you need.
So listen to this. So I got this story. So I was going to the store one day. And I had Xavier in the back seat. So it was this lady sitting. She was out of her car, but in the middle lane, two lanes this way, two lanes the other way. But she was in the middle turning lane.
Mm-hmm.
Her car was, I guess, out of gas because she had a gas can in her hand. So I was like, okay, Xavier, like, you know, I'm trying to school him on, like, people need help. Let's give her a few dollars so she can get some gas. She clearly needs help. So we do a U-turn, and we're going to turn around and, like, give her a few dollars for gas.
Mm-hmm.
So when we turn around, like, she started throwing a gas can at the cars that were passing. And I was like, what just happened? So I don't even know. And I was like, oh, no, we're not going to stop because now I don't know what's going on. So we're going to keep going.
Right. She didn't turn violent quick.
I feel like she about to appreciate the help that we about to give her. So we're going to turn back around and go to where we were going because he was like, "Ma, what is she doing?" And I'm like, "I have no idea. Like, I don't know what she is doing." But yeah, I feel like if you're not gonna appreciate it, I'm not doing it. So I didn't even stop because I was like, now she violent, and I'm like, maybe she on drugs. I don't know what was going on.
That reminds me, I think
I was like, absolutely not. I'm not stopping because now I'm like, I don't know what you're doing.
It's not safe no more. You didn't took it from a regular to an unsafety situation.
I probably didn't went and got gas and everything. Like no ma'am.
So Katie, do you remember this? I think it was like maybe 3 years ago. We was riding up a road. I was state of road, but a lot of our listeners are out of state, so they might not realize the road anyway. But we was riding up a road, and it was wintertime, and it was an older individual.
Oh, I know what you're about to say.
That was walking
I remember.
This lady was walking on ice.
It was a man.
A man walking on ice, and he fell. And we seen him walking on ice as we was riding past, and I seen him fall in my rearview mirror. So I pull over, run back, help dog up, right?
Mm-hmm.
I'm like, you good? He's, yeah, I'm good.
He was drunk as hell.
Drunk as all get out, right? But I'm helping him up.
Every
I'm like, you good?
80.
And I help. So I try to help dog off the ice. I'm like, you good? Yeah, I'm good. I'm good. All right, cool. Get him off the ice. By the time I got back to the car, dog then walked on back to the ice again and fell again.
He might be there all night.
There's
so much you can do.
So, yeah, because at some point, I'm thinking to myself, like, did I help him the wrong way?
No.
Like, should I help him on the other side of the ice?
No, he just drunk.
No, he was on the ice.
He was just drunk.
So yeah. I'm like, all right, man. But,
no, you went back and helped him again.
Yeah, because
he helped him like 4 or 5 times. And then he said,
you got to move him away from that area.
He said, can we just take you where you're going? Like, can you just get in the car? Like,
yeah, that's
because
how, like, you gotta
the second
from
time,
that
remember
area.
The second time you helped him, you bagged up.
Yeah.
And then he got out the car. He fell again. So he said, can I just take you where you're going? He said, no, I'm going to them apartments right there. So right there was probably like maybe 10 feet away.
Yeah.
20, like it was super steps. Close. And he was like, no, I'm going right here. I'm going right here. So he was like, okay, well, let me walk with you.
Mm-hmm.
No, don't walk with me. Don't walk with me. So then the man just stood there. So he got back in the car. And he was like, let's just say a prayer really quick because I hope he make it. Like, I hope he don't fall and then bust his head because he wouldn't get in the car and he wouldn't allow him to walk him to the apartment. Mm-hmm. So we had to pull off.
Mm-hmm.
But DTM did not want to pull off. He was like, "What should we follow him?" And I was like, no, because then we're going to look like creeps. And he's going to keep falling.
Mm.
Right.
And so we just pulled off. And I was like, well, maybe somebody else will...
I just hope he made it to that destination.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because my thing is always, man, if you ever in my presence and you look like or ask for help and I don't give it to you, I'm going to feel horrible.
Especially if I see you on the news later.
Yeah, especially if I'd had it to give. Like, if I had the time or if I had the dollar that you asked for that you were trying to get some gas or $10, whatever it is, you know what I'm saying? I ain't trying to support your habit, but if you literally legit need help,
that's the problem, though. And we never know who really needs help. That's the problem. Because I used to give money all the time until I saw, like, the schemes that people were doing. And I'm like, you're not even really homeless.
People get rich off of that.
Yes.
First of all, I seen a bitch begging.
And that's what deterred me from
doing it. I seen a bitch begging Friday.
Because
Ty said, she looked nice. Why she got that sign? The bitch hair curl, the puffy Darion coat with the fur on the hood.
She forgot what job she was going to.
Fucking.
She put the wrong clothes on.
She didn't look.
She like, she snap.
She did not look for this job.
She left work and didn't have time to go home to change her bum clothes.
She did not look like, which I know sometimes people give items, right?
Right.
Mm-hmm. So let's not take away from the fact that she had a nice coat or whatever. But even her shoes were clean.
I'm about to say, but you got to look at the whole outfit, even the face, the everything. Like,
only thing she was missing was makeup, bitch. You look nice. Because Taz was like, she's awfully clean to need help from us.
Right.
I'm like.
And that's what makes me not give money anymore. Because I'm like, you never know. Like, if they clearly need it, then I will. But, I mean, you can't tell.
You never can tell. And then I feel like I would rather buy you a meal.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like,
But what I like
but
is
they be
the
cussing
people,
you out.
But what I like is the people that be honest. I like the James,
for James. James,
let me know what you about to do, because if you don't want food, don't be letting me give you this $10 talking about you about to get some food.
James,
you
know, would tell
let
you.
Let me know what you about to do.
James like, would tell you, like, I'm hungry. I'm hungry. If he wasn't hungry, I don't want that. I'm just trying to go get high.
What used to tell my cousin? This is when we worked at the bar. He used to tell my cousin, no, I want to get high today.
Yeah, be honest.
Or, and my cousin would be like, all right. And he'd give him like $5 or
whatever. Be honest. Because I'm going to give it to you when you're more honest.
I'm hungry.
Yeah.
We'd order him whatever he wanted from the bar and give him. He'd eat it. Or if he wanted to get drunk, he'd be like, no, can I get some beer?
He was specific. Like, no, I can't eat that. Please don't order me that. I can't eat that. Because he ain't had no teeth. You know what I'm saying? So he was like, don't try to give me no steak because I ain't got no teeth.
Yeah, yeah, he used to like, I'm going to suck the juice off of it. Like the mashed potatoes.
The soft stuff.
Yeah. Maybe like a burger with no bread. Mm-hmm. Like something soft, like you said. But he was, loved him. Like, he was my favorite bum.
Honest.
And not only that.
Favorite bum.
Not only that.
Did she just say that?
Because he wasn't homeless. Because he said, no, I got a house. But he will also sweep the parking lot. Pick up all the trash.
See, he put in his work.
You know what I'm saying?
Put in his work.
There's a thing. If he was hungry, he would just ask for food. But if he wanted to get high or drunk, he would work for it. Remember? He'd be like, no, I want money. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to sweep.
You put in your work.
He used to be out there holding the sign like the arrow, like during construction and shit. We're open, whatever. He used to work. If he wanted to get drunk or high, he would work for
it. That's what I'm saying.
But for food, put your he would just ask for it.
Right.
But anything else, he would work for it. Yeah, he used to be running to people, cars, all types of shit. Like, bro, he was the truth. Man. He was my favorite bum.
She is so funny.
I've been looking for him. Maybe he passed by now. That was a long time ago. But I feel like we should have intervened for him.
He wouldn't have paid that no attention.
We did intervention.
So, okay, let's get to the last one, then we let them go.
Okay.
We done held them for a while today. Well, but I know they loving it though. All right, so my ex, in parentheses, I'm married now. Sweet talked me into before we get to this. Before we get to this, I'm sorry. I know we gotta let y'all go soon, but is there a time limit on closure? When you speak in relationship wise,
I mean, if you moved on to another relationship, it should be, you should be, you should have your closure if you moved on and got married.
Because how can you open another bag if you ain't finished the way
in? No. Okay. No. So we break up, right?
Uh huh.
You get married.
Mm-hmm. Oh, you
didn't
not
get married.
Oh.
Well,
might not have your closure here.
That's what I'm saying. So is there a time limit on closure?
It's not really. I mean, everybody, it's different for everybody. So
You can't
tell me when I'm supposed to get over you.
Like, that's what I'm saying. We always tell people you can't heal from your trauma.
Yeah,
nobody can put a time limit on your trauma.
Yeah, you can't.
Hey. Breaking up is trauma.
So you know what
But you would know because it'd be drama.
So
there's drama behind the trauma.
Because they still want your ass.
Yeah, and do.
So here's what I use in my newly added breakthrough for relationship. Right? So often we hear and we say, you can't tell me when I can get over stuff.
You can't. That's a true statement.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
That part is true.
Mm-hmm.
But the part that we don't say is that you need to tell you.
Mm-hmm. Oh,
when it's time to get over.
Well, that's true.
Now, that shouldn't last forever,
that's what I'm saying.
Honestly, it shouldn't last forever. Like, it's a time period, but you don't know it. But it shouldn't be 15 years. And y'all been divorced for 15 years, and you still harboring on what y'all could have had. Like,
that's the thing.
Not going to happen.
But I feel like me and you together 22 years, right?
I mean, a few years.
You can't expect me to get over you in a year.
Yeah, right. I'm like, a few years, you should have been healed.
I can't expect you to get over me in a year. But I can expect you to not expect me to let you take 22 years.
Yeah.
Like, we've been there 22 years. It's going to take at least 22 years to get over. No.
Yeah.
You know
what I'm saying? That's not going to happen.
No.
Yeah.
Like,
but I think it's each his own.
I say it's different for everybody. Because some people get divorced and be remarried within 1 year.
I was just finna say, my brother was with his recent girlfriend, 27 years, I think.
Mm-hmm.
He engaged to somebody else right now. Broke up. A month ago.
You never know.
But this is the thing, though.
You never know.
This is what I pushed to some of my couples after recent, because they hit me, right? The brain is so powerful.
It is. I agree.
If you want to lose weight, and you say, you know what? I got a wedding in 2 months. I need to lose 15 pounds in 2 months.
Women ought to do it for sure.
You're going to lose 15 pounds
we
in 2 months.
We not eating shit.
Because
nothing.
You put
nothing.
You know why?
No sugar.
We drink
no carbs.
We drink
no
water.
Sweets. No nothing.
Simply we air. Drinking water. Simply
and,
air.
Hey, simply air.
No calories, no carbs, no sugar.
But this is what I'm saying. So because your mindset, I got 2 months to take off 15, 20 pounds, yeah. Right? You're only giving yourself them 2 months to take it off.
Yeah.
Oh, that's true.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
If you're like, I need to get this house by June,
yeah.
You're going to save up the money you need.
On everything else except that. Huh?
Exactly. Because you're, and that's the thing. So listen. If I say,
but it's different with your heart. Your heart is not like losing weight and stuff. Like you can say, but look, you can say I want to be over here in 6 months. But then something like happens and it just reminds you of him. And then you right back in it, like, oh my god.
But Kiki, look, that's the problem.
That's different.
Most people, and I'm gonna say most people never even say. I got 6 months to get over this.
Well,
and
you
it's
don't
a
have
wrap.
A time limit on it because it's just your heart, though.
And like, that's the thing.
Even if you said a number, it's not going to be true.
If you get
because it's how you feel.
But
that's
what I'm saying is how your brain works. Is if you tell yourself, let's say them same 15, 20 pounds, right? Mm-hmm. You want to lose. I want to lose 15, 20 pounds
in
a year.
A year? Why the fuck is going to take a whole year to lose 15
right.
pounds?
Exactly. That's the point I'm making. But your brain is going to make you take the whole year to lose them 15, 20 pounds. Because that's how the brain works. You know what I'm saying? But if you tell yourself, I need to be over this. I need to get over. Even if you have setbacks where something reminds you, like, oh, I just need to take a day. Or I just need to take a minute. You heal it. It's like if you get shot, you're not giving yourself a year to get over. You're like, I got shot. I need to get back to work.
That's true.
You know what I'm saying? I'm still hurt.
You know what? That's like when we had Taz, right?
Yeah.
The doctor like, you got to be here for 3 days. Oh no, nigga, I'm leaving today.
Checked out.
What I gotta do? He said you gotta walk from that corner to that corner.
She out here looking like her mama walking down that hall, just crinkle, crinkle, crinkle,
because,
all the way to the end.
Yeah,
because her mind.
I gotta get to my baby.
Mm-hmm.
I was in so much pain. What I was like,
mm-hmm.
I know it don't hurt at all. He was like, you know it hurt. I said, no, it don't.
And that's what I'm saying.
But that's different. But that's different with your heart, though. But my thing is that's for your baby, though. But if you don't have another relationship waiting, you just there. It's gonna take two months to get over.
But that's
yourself.
You healing for yourself. You're not healing for your next relationship.
But that's not what most people. That's not.
That's
what I'm
saying. That's what I'm putting out there.
Yeah,
that's
not what I'm thinking.
People not for one, you're not healing for the right reason.
Yeah.
For two, you're not really giving yourself. The ample, what you know, to heal.
Mm-hmm.
Most people jump from one to the next.
Because it's easier.
It's easier, right.
It's easier to move on. It's easier to move on.
And it's not because you're used to the...
If you never truly heal, your next thing probably not going to be that successful.
And the thing is...
Well, it's never really that successful, the next relationship.
But it's not because you...
Because it's your rebound.
It's your rebound. That last relationship.
And it's not because you're used to the person... You used to being in a relationship.
Yeah, you used to being with...
Somebody.
Like... honestly, me used to like break up right now, right?
Mm-hmm.
What would I do? Like, who's gonna go to the store with me? You know what I'm saying? Like, just little stuff, not right. like even huge things. Mm-hmm. I ain't even talking about the financial aspect. I'm talking about the little stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Like, who's gonna go to the grocery store with me? Even when I go to the grocery store by myself, I call you because right. it's like being at the grocery store by myself is weird.
Weird.
Because right. we've been together 22 years, but we've been living together. For 20 years.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Since our oldest son was born.
You have to get your groceries delivered like me. Boom.
Done deal.
Problem you know solved.
What? Done deal. She just eliminated your husband just that quick. Right. See? I just told we talked about her earlier.
Who gonna pump my gas?
We talked about her earlier, didn't we? We talked about her.
Oh, you that person, huh?
Yeah, we just talked about her earlier.
Girl, you don't need that nigga. Let me show you shop cart. What's that shit called? Instacart.
For me, it was hard because, I mean, we were doing everything together. So, like, of course, it was a slow process trying to learn how to do everything myself.
By yourself.
I mean, like you said, it takes time. It's not gonna happen overnight.
Yeah.
But I mean, I had to learn how to do shit by myself. Like,
so what's the?
I was with him since I was 19, so I was a baby.
Like your whole life, really? Like,
not
your whole life in the future, but
my
your
whole adult
life to that point.
My whole adult life.
You like to this point?
My
I don't know nothing
I came
but you.
Straight from my parents to you, so that my whole adult life.
From the porch.
So just
you got
so
me off the porch, my nigga.
Just so y'all know, y'all not getting this until the next week. But this next ask KD that matching what we talking about, y'all not getting this until next week. Just so y'all know. But the question that
we
I have,
ran out of time.
Yeah, we definitely ran out of time. But the question that I want to leave the guys with is for Kiki. Mm-hmm. How hard is it for you to transition from, okay, first you with this dude, mm-hmm. right? Doing everything together. Mm-hmm. Then y'all break up and get a divorce. And now you adjusted to doing everything by yourself, mm-hmm. right?
Well, I still but don't now, do everything by myself, but...
But somewhat.
Yeah. I had to at some point.
Right. So at the point where you were doing everything by yourself. Yeah. But then you had to make another transition to be able to trust that it was still fun and safe to do something
with somebody else.
Yeah. How hard was that transition?
Yeah.
Was it a hard transition or was it like, okay.
No, it was difficult because, of course, trusting anybody is difficult. Because right. I don't really trust people. So trusting people is a hard process. It took time, especially when you have kids, you know? Yep. Like, I'd be more concerned about my kids than I do for myself. Yep. So that in itself was the whole process. I had to make sure my kids were comfortable first, and then I kind of got more comfortable once the kids got comfortable. Then I was like, okay, well, this might be cool.
Because I remember, like, when you all first got divorced, well, when you guys weren't technically divorced but living separately.
Yeah.
On Christmas, but you say you guys still did do this, which I didn't know. Mm-hmm. But you guys wake up on Christmas together.
Yeah, we still do Christmas together.
Because that not for me, not for you, it's but for the kids. For our kids.
Oh yeah, we still do everything with the kids together.
Yeah, and I love that though.
Whatever, who he's with and who I'm with, that doesn't matter. Yeah. It still will always be Christmas together. Period. Like, and if anybody has a problem with it, like it's just gonna be their problem.
Because that's never gonna change. And the thing is because as a unit. We made an adult decision not to be together. Well, first we made the adult decision to be together.
Right.
Then we made the adult decision to have children. Mm-hmm. We made the adult decision to get married. Mm-hmm. We made the adult decision to get divorced.
Yeah.
We cannot let our adult decisions fuck our children. Kids up. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Because if what they're saying is, I just want for Christmas for us all to wake up together.
Yeah.
Open presents together. Mm-hmm. And just that moment.
Yeah.
How dare we as adults tell them no?
Yeah.
Well, my boyfriend don't like
they
that.
They never really or said daddy it. Girlfriend that's just something like we just kept going.
I was about
and
to say,
I can't stop it. You know what I mean?
And like, that's easier you said than done too. Because we just did a wedding with the ex wife wasn't feeling nothing
well,
from
but it
the,
does depend on how you end the relationship. Yeah, like, we didn't end
say.
On like a bad note.
You know what I'm saying about that?
So it's like it depends on how you end.
This the vibe I got from that though. I feel like the dad
left the mom
for the present wife.
Yeah,
because
so that's difficult.
Because when we said step, because the bride said I have two moms, so I want my stepmom to walk and I want my mom to walk. Mm-hmm. When I, as the coordinator at that time, said, okay, all the parents line up. I said, we're going to do groom's parents because they're still together. Mm-hmm. I said, we're going to do stepmom and then we're going to do my mom because I was, you know, birth mom just sounds adopted, right? Mm. Her mom looked at me and said, she's walking down the aisle? I said, per your daughter, yes. Why didn't anyone tell me? I said,
they told her at the last minute.
No, they told her.
They let KD beat it.
So you found out today.
They
right
let
now,
KD drop that news.
I told her two days
before the wedding, by the way.
She said, she said, so why didn't anyone tell me?
Mm,
I said,
I just did.
You have a responsibility. You better take it.
I just did.
I said, you'll have to have a discussion
with
your
daughter. Yeah.
Not right now.
Oh my gosh.
Like she
but, after I said that, the whole fucking so we had a conversation like single ladies like for the bouquet toss, right? Because they were doing a bouquet toss but not a garter toss because they seem pretty conservative, right? So the taking the garter off made the bride feel uncomfortable. So we're like single ladies. So the groom's mom told the bride's biological mom, hey, you should get out there. Oh, I'll never get married again. Yeah, that one.
And she was for sure.
I'm talking about she had a...
Look, the new wife was like, it's okay, babe. Grabbed his hand.
She was like, we're good. She was like,
you're
rubbing
good.
His back. I was like, Cause mom was taking shots.
Like, I had to pull mom aside the day of the wedding.
Yeah.
To tell her, like, listen, you, whatever your issues are, you need to put
that
aside.
That's not the right time for this.
This day is for your daughter.
Yeah, this is not the right day for
her. Don't forget to smile. They're taking pictures. She said, there's nothing to smile about.
I told her, I said, it's not your...
It's your daughter. She was still
your,
mad.
It's not your ex-daughter.
She was crying.
It's not your daughter-in-law. It's not a friend of your daughter. This is your daughter, your birth. You gave birth to this woman.
Some people don't take it that way.
And I'm like, your only goal for today is to make sure that her day goes perfect.
But that's how the Braxtons are. Like, they can't accept the fact that he moved on, you know what I'm saying, and married the woman that he cheated on their mother with. Like, they're like absolutely... want nothing to do.
But you know, I think for her mom feels betrayed because your dad left us or whatever.
And I get, but how many years ago was that? You got to move on. It's never like a time limit on being hurt.
But even if it was yesterday, you don't want me to have a daddy?
Yeah.
No. You know what I'm saying? Like, yeah, no, as a kid, this is my thing. If DTM left me right now for another woman, and they got married or whatever, right? I don't expect my kids to not talk to their daddy.
Exactly.
First of all, we got a friend.
I don't get that.
We have a friend that actually happened to. Right?
I don't get it.
Where her ex-husband married his side bitch, right?
Mm-hmm.
She don't tell her kids not to interact with him.
Right.
Yeah. But she do say.
I would still be hurt. I
respect
mean, that,
me as your
that
mother.
Hurt would be probably forever. But when you got kids, you can't tell your kids not to go see their father or
go to
the wedding or go
fuck that nigga.
Certain stuff with them. Like,
fuck that nigga.
I'm not taking no pictures, but I'm not doing no family pictures.
Even when her ex-husband got remarried, the present wife asked for their daughter, our friend and her ex-husband's daughter, to be her. She called it daughter of honor.
I mean, I probably wouldn't be in the wedding.
She declined.
I wouldn't be in the wedding.
But she did decline.
But I would go.
But our friend allowed that to be her daughter's choice.
Yeah, exactly.
What you want to do?
Don't make them choices for them.
I will not stand up there.
Like.
Now, her son was the best man, but he felt more like. So this is how they felt.
It's different for men and women.
Right. But he felt like I'm standing next to my daddy,
yeah,
of course.
It's different for men and
but
women.
But her daughter said, I'm not finna stand next to her.
Mm-hmm.
And when she tried to do family pictures, the daughter and the son both walked out the studio.
I wouldn't have did family
because pictures. Because she was there. Yeah. The daughter was there to do graduation pictures.
Mm-hmm.
So the daddy gonna try to be slick. Oh, we just gonna all take pictures together for your graduation.
I'm not doing that.
She said, no, we not.
I wouldn't have did that either.
She left.
That's too far. Like,
she left out. So now recently they have been saying like you can bring her to things. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
But you don't get to sit at the table though. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Like me, my mama, my daddy, we gonna sit here.
Mm-hmm.
You gonna sit over there.
Mm-hmm.
Because at the end of the
day. I mean, that's a difficult situation though.
It is.
It's difficult. But you can't ruin your daughter's wedding because of that, though. Like, so, you got to kind of just be chill.
So I asked this question, I think, on one of the previous podcasts. But, so, like, once you're in a relationship of that magnitude, right? And do you still feel like it's certain things that that other person shouldn't come to?
Yes.
Yeah.
Like weddings and funerals and like,
I mean, depending on how that relationship ended,
if we break up, me and KD break up, I got my new girl, you know what I'm saying? We doing our thing, whatever. And I owe the son slip getting married. Should she not attend the wedding?
Your new bitch?
Yeah.
I mean, she can attend, but she can't sit at the family table.
Is there a time
frame? I mean, it depends on how, like you said, how things ended. Like
if it's the first,
you know what I'm saying?
Because if it's the first year.
I wouldn't care. Like,
if it's the first year, is that one time frame? Or is it 2 years later? It
should be like, okay. Again, you can't put a time limit on it. But I mean, I guess if like, because this is my thing. You and I are his parents, right?
Mm-hmm.
So if it's a matter of parent table, our significant others got to sit somewhere else.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Unless it's okay with him.
Mm-hmm.
To me, it matters about the comfortability of the child.
Mm-hmm.
And my thing is this, like, I think you can put a time on it, but I just think every time will be different.
It's different.
But I feel like you have to, not that you can't, I feel like you have to put a time on what's hurting you.
Mm-hmm.
Because if not, then you're gonna just let it work run its course. It's kind of like,
well,
you
know, some like, people never heal though.
And that's, but the and problem, then, the reason why then, is because you're not intentional about the healing. Because
they still want that person.
But and then it's too right. Like if me and you was to like break up like today, right? And mm-hmm. then something happened to my daddy tomorrow. I don't expect you to bring another bitch to my.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? Right. Like, right. It gotta be like some. Understanding. First of all, but, I always got to be a conversation. And that, how you feel about me yeah. pulling up? Because I remember, yeah. I remember when you and I remember when you and I were broken up. Conversation. I remember
because you're not bringing another bitch to my house. That's even what I'm even saying. With my ex, like he asked, like, can I bring my girl to you know the party at your house? I don't care. Like, yeah. But the fact that you asked is that's got to be a conversation
because it got to be respectable,
you,
yeah, right?
Got to
just like
because if she just showed up and you hadn't said anything. And then she would have had her feelings hurt.
Yeah, because
you know what I'm saying. Because you didn't say anything. Not that I want you, but you got to have a conversation about it.
Respect.
I would never bring my nigga to your house without saying.
I was about to say that.
He coming. You know what I'm saying?
Y'all know each other and y'all have each other, but I'm still not about to just have him pop up.
That's always still gonna be a sore spot because we were married. Like you still gotta have that respect.
And let me play this real quick because I think this is like one. I don't got with it. No, it's not the right one, but it's cool. But what the one thing that y'all said
it's
was
it's not the right one.
Definitely not the right one. Definitely not the right one. But what you said was you have to have that communication.
You gotta talk.
Everything that I've learned, mm-hmm. no matter what situation it is. Mm-hmm. The reason why people feel the way they feel is because there was a lack of communication somewhere. Yeah. So,
and it's harder for some situations than others. Like ours was, we're okay. We still communicate. We still talk. But I mean, for some people, I mean, if it was cheating and it was somebody that I done got with somebody that I was cheating with on the side, that would be a different conversation. Like that would, he probably would feel some type of way, or I would feel some type of way if it was still that same person. So, I mean, I don't know. It would be different.
Yeah.
We cool with our relationship now, but yeah, it would be different if it was something else.
And that's the thing. Like I said, it's really everything that we just said boils down to a lack of communication.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Some people, you moving more off of assumption than you are having a verbal communication mm-hmm. or a conversation. Like open your mouth and talk about what's happening, what's going on. And I think the hardest part, especially for people who are breaking up or who have broken up,
mm-hmm.
Due to. You know, somebody infidelity or abuse problem or whatever, mm-hmm. you don't want to face that person to have that conversation.
Yeah.
But you, at some point, have to. Now, I'm not going to say if somebody's abusing you, you got to think differently because I don't mm-hmm. want to put you back into that situation. Mm-hmm. But, you know, you got to think outside the box and figure out where it's safe at to have this conversation. Yeah. But have mm-hmm. the conversation.
You definitely got
to
have a conversation.
To set things down or put things in perspective.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying? Exactly. Like, we all assume. It's so many cases, man, that I deal with people who are married and people who are in relationship where the only problem that you are having is that you constantly assuming.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you assume that somebody mad. You assume that somebody happy. You assume that somebody wrong.
That's why a lot of the relationships don't work.
Yeah, because you're assuming you constantly everything. Assuming.
Nobody talking. And I'm one for talking. Like, I want to know what's going on. Like, why are you acting different? What's going on? Like, tell me.
And
don't just hold it in and tell me at the last minute. Like,
but you know what the second part of
it. Now everything coming out. Now we just saying reckless shit. Now we not even talking.
The first part is that we assume.
Yeah.
The second part is we don't spend enough time to even feel like what's wrong with me. I can't even explain to you what's wrong with me.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know.
Yeah.
I'm saying because I never took the time to assess my issue.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? So I can't explain it to you because I can't explain it to me.
Myself, right. You know? Mm-hmm.
So, sometimes you can't explain it because you don't want to hurt people's feelings, though.
Yeah, but can you ever, I mean, have you ever been through something where you couldn't explain it to yourself?
But more often than not, it's like, what's wrong with you? And it's like, nothing. Because
I do that.
I don't want to really tell you what's wrong with me. Because then you're going to be like, well, damn.
But a lot of times, I don't want to mess up. Like, if we've been getting along and, like, being straight, like, I don't want to mess up the moment.
Because sometimes like, we're reflecting.
But then I see stuff and I just be like, I'm not going to say nothing this time. I'm not going to say nothing this time. I'm not going to say nothing this time. And then when I say it, like, everything come out. Because it's like, now I've been harboring all this stuff.
He'd be like, when I did that, I don't know, about 6 months ago.
Yeah.
So listen,
first of all, another thing.
As a phenomenal producer, as a phenomenal producer, I'm going to have to stop it right there. You know why? Oh. Because I want people to tune into the next one. Because we're going to continue at this exact spot.
Who going to remember?
I am.
Okay.
The phenomenal producer. We're going to continue at this exact spot.
Yeah, got us all riled up.
Make sure you tune in. And that's the thing, because this is the part that people need to hear.
I'm like, argh!
You know what I'm saying? And I was at first going to let it go and cut it, but I'm like, no. We're going to let him come back next week. We're going to get it in. And you're going to be able to marinate on the feelings and come back even stronger about how you feel. Mm-hmm.
I know, I'm so mad right now.
So, right. I love that. So, with that being said, man, we appreciate y'all listening. Make sure that you tune in to Marriage Materials. Make sure you tune in to Wolf Talk. You know what I'm saying? And so we here Monday, Wednesday, and Fridays. We got you completely covered. Make sure y'all are safe during these holiday season.
Oh, so we're going to start that week. Yes. Have them on hump day. And end that week.
Indeed.
We the shit.
Indeed.
Hey, hey, I just thought about it. We the shit.
You know what I'm saying? So we definitely appreciate y'all coming through. We are on iHeart. We are on YouTube. Or wherever you get your podcast.
Wherever.
Dying
sing. You feel
me?
This
should be my
song. So, with that being said, bye, man, bye. I am your gracious host. You know what I'm saying? The one and only DTM, Dr. DTM.
Your girl, KD.
And your hostess with the mostest, Kiki.
And we will most definitely see you next week.
She over here gigging.
Peace.
Deuces.
Bye, bye, bye.